Zenix Storm. So they're old lane partners, so they have a sense of each other's play styles, that's for sure.
Sure enough. Well, here we go. Picks and bans for game number one between KT Rolster and Spenu. Sonic Boom, the Ezreal, first banned out by KT. And again, we are in patch 5.12, guys. That Runeglaive Ezreal is pretty good. Pretty strong pick right now. And they also saw what Sossen did with it, too, the last time he got his hands on it.
And there is going to be a Rumble ban against Soul.
Thresh ban against Peekaboo.
Well, you don't want Peekaboo on a playmaking champion. We've seen him just take over games on Thresh, really carry the team. He already did that when they played against Najin in his first set. So
I wonder if this is going to open up the possibility of a first pick Alistar, though, for KT.
Definitely could be a factor here. It's a pocket ban, definitely. The Thresh only really worried about Peekaboo on it. And that's going to be, of course, Kalista. We know Arrow does well on that champion. Now for KT, I imagine they're just going to try and first pick Azir if they're not afraid of the Vel'Koz.
I wonder. I mean, again, we haven't seen Sossen really win that matchup, but he did make it difficult for Faker for a little while anyway when he played against SK Telecom.
Yeah, Faker went 0-3-0 in lane. And that changed. When they played against Samsung, Crown did a lot better against that Vel'Koz with the Azir. So they may not think it's quite as bad, and they're almost certainly ready for that counter pick, considering that Spenu has played it in both of their last two best of threes.
There's one final ban for Spenu Sonic Boom, and we'll see what it's going to be. There's a lot of good stuff still out on the board. Are they worried about scores? Echo? Do they want to keep the Maokai away? The Rise will be the ban. And so that does leave some pretty strong picks open for both KT and Spenu. Will it be the Alistar, or are they going to go for something like Maokai, maybe a Rek'Sai for score? What do you think?
Yeah, that's the question. Is it going to be the Rek'Sai or the Azir? Because the Alistar obviously up as well, but the Azir pick has been heavily prioritized by KT recently. I mean, we were only looking at Nagne's record, but Edge also has played a bunch of Azir before Nagne came back in the middle of the series against CJ. I believe it has been picked in all five of KT's last five games.
Wow.
So this would be number six.
We may actually see Catch take that Echo away from score.
Well, he was actually one of the first players to play Jungle Echo. I think he was the first player to play Jungle Echo in Champion.
Yeah, I believe so.
So we know he's comfortable on it, and score really likes that pick right now for a very good reason. Tons of crowd control that you can offer. You're still doing decent damage even after the 5/12 nerfs. But the way you can play in a front line with Echo, if you're good at landing that parallel convergence, is huge for those big, big stuns.
Well, Sol may grab the Hecarim here just to have something to put a little bit more pressure on with.
Now, I wouldn't do this.
Nope.
Yeah, I wouldn't take the Hecarim against Someday, because he's a player. Someday's a player, the Maokai much better, that flourishes with early advantages. And when you put yourself into a hole with Hecarim, a champion that needs items to actually get powerful, you give Someday a really big opportunity to just kick your butt in lane and then snowball the rest of the game. So I think this is a good draft. Maokai, Echo, you're taking away two of KT's most prominent champions at the same time.
I don't think Score is going to be too worried to play that Evelynn, though, in the jungle if they decide to lock that in. And still plenty of good picks out there for KT. I was kind of wondering about that Nautilus. I mean, Spenu was hovering over it. We talked about playmaking supports. I mean, Nautilus certainly one capable of doing that as well, too. Someday could take that Fizz.
And this is such a Someday style of
champion
to play, right? We've seen the Fizz into the Maokai matchup. It's a common counter pick here in Korea right now, the Trinity Force Fizz into the Maokai. We've seen players get solo kills on it. Someday must be very confident going into this lane.
Yeah, well, you can't blame him in the matchup. We'll see what Spenu picks for their next two here. Do you just go for the bot lane here and leave the mid for last? I would imagine.
Yes, you probably should do that, even though you can see the mid laner already. You'd think that they were just going to take the Sivir right now and try and make some plays around that champion. They could just try it. Spenu could just try and take all of KT's champions, too, and see what happens. Although, I don't really think that's going to be effective. If you take the Kog'Maw, Arrow will have something else up his sleeve. But here's the thing about KT. KT wants standard lanes after you see that Fizz pick into the Maokai. So if you take the Kog'Maw, you can at least punish their duo lane if you end up in standard lanes, because that's a lane bully champion in the early game that a lot of the current meta champions can't really deal with that effectively. You do tend to get poked out. So Spenu could just hedge their bets with a Kog'Maw.
I would love to see the Zillion too, actually. Putting that up. Wow. Oh, Victor at the last second. All right. I was going to say, you can put the bombs on the Echo and the Maokai, but I guess it's going to be Victor for Sossin.
Yeah, unfortunately, I don't really think Zillion is in the best state right now, so.
Well, it hasn't stopped them from some of their other picks, so you never know with Spenu. What do you think about this Caitlyn? She did get some buffs recently. Obviously, the headshot has some armor penetration now, which could be pretty decent against Maokai if he ends up building that.
We haven't seen new Caitlyn in Korea yet. I'd be very intrigued to see it. And Caitlyn and Nunu would be a bully lane here that would match the Kog'Maw range. That would be great.
Yeah, Caitlyn, Annie, that gives Peekaboo the chance to make some plays. I love it. Yeah. I'd love to see this new Caitlyn, too.
Yeah, and this is something we haven't seen yet in Korea since the Caitlyn changes, that passive, but nope, just going to go with the Sivir.
Oh, well.
That's still going to be a tough lane for Arrow and Peekaboo to be in, especially if they want to leave Arrow by himself to farm. Well, Peekaboo makes plays on the map because he's going to just get poked really, really heavily by that Corki. There's a huge range differential between Sivir's basic attack range and the bioarcane barrage of Kog'Maw.
I do like the Nautilus here.
Yeah, you want something tanky so you don't get all in, basically, because as much as Kog'Maw can poke and win that lane, you still have to be afraid of a level 6 all in from Sivir and Annie and a jungler getting on top of the Kog'Maw. So I think the Nautilus is certainly a good pick here. It's a good secondary engage. You can also pop it onto Fizz and kind of change his play style, or you just go for the Alistar, which is something Secret's played a lot of this season.
Yeah,
still gonna be a tanky champion.
Yep.
I do not think Karma is safe.
Well, I think it's gonna be Alistar. There we go. Switching it back, playing games with our heart. Nope, it will be Alistar for Spenu Sonic Boom. So we got a little bit of durability in the lane now, at least a little bit of sustain. What do you think about this? KT certainly looks like they just want to get in there, get kills, and end the sync quick, don't they?
This is a very, very all-in style of composition. A lot of comfort picks for these players. I'm curious to see how Score works with Sunday to help this top side, because you really want to get that advantage with the Ignite Fizz against the Maokai, and then you can just snowball out of control on that champion. We've seen players like Marin go 10 kills on a Fizz in this matchup and just take over a game. So that should be their focus. And they're going to have some very strong skirmishing early. Another thing to watch for is Score and Peekaboo have gotten extremely good at playing vision during the laning phase. They are almost always on the same page when it comes to putting in deep wards in the enemy jungle. It was a major factor in their victory over CJ because they were so much better at it than MadLife and Ambition were. So we're seeing a very high degree of synergy between these two players already. Mm-hmm. And I have to believe it's only going to get better as time goes on. I've been really, really impressed.
It certainly does seem that way. I mean, we talked earlier about how good Fixer was for KT, but Peekaboo seems to be like that and then some. You know, I mean, providing the shot calling while still providing all that playmaking. Yeah, really big pickup for KT, and certainly could be what would propel them to a 2-0 in this match and then possibly propel them to Worlds a little bit later this year. We'll see how this game goes, though. It's time to get onto Summoner's Rift and see who takes it. Here we go. Game number one between KT and Spenu. Decent cheer for Spenu from the crowd today. It is a full house, as usual, here in Yongsan, Seoul, South Korea. And all five members of Spenu actually moving towards the top side of the map, along with KT lurking in the bush.
I guess we're seeing more pool party Rek'Sai. Yeah. Being a shark on a jet ski.
Well, Peekaboo's got that AoE stun loaded up here, so, oh boy, some days like, yep. Gotta check that one.
Found him in the brush.
Yep, good check with the sapling. That's a dangerous prospect, too, when you've got that Annie with that level 1 AoE stun powered up.
Yeah, and we see Spenu here. He's trying to get some of these deep wards in. Are they actually going to go for a buff steal? Looks like they're pinging out the blue buff, but this could prompt an invade at the last second. Yeah, I think it's maybe a little bit risky to do this.
Yeah.
Like Spenu definitely. Oh, they're going to go for it, actually.
All right.
Now,
well,
they know there's a ward in the pixel brush, and there are pings from Spenu going down on the tri brush because they know there's a long route through their own jungle. that could be abused by KT to ambush them. But KT just going to respond with some jungle pressure of their own. They are not actually seen by that ward heading into the enemy jungle. So they're just going to trade for the red buff right now. And we'll see if anybody actually gets the three buff. This is a very weird jungle path that's going to happen. But the lane swap is called, and Spenu is going to get up there in the top side, which means they get someday in the 1v1 that they wanted. And that's going to be pretty nice, as we see a very awkward switch in the lane here as both duos just walk past each other to their respective sides of the map.
Yeah, pretty much. That was a bit of an odd start.
The new coin, or buffed coin, I should say, on Alistar this game. He's been seeing more of that on the champion these days.
Oh, I love it, man. I've just been building coin on pretty much everything I've been playing lately. It's nice to have that active back quickly again.
Catch sticking around in this side of the jungle when there's a duo lane there for a really long time. He may regret this. He can't duel with Score early. Score also full HP.
Yeah, no,
he's
going to
get
seen.
He's
got that red buff, too.
Okay.
Oh, yeah, finds a wild catch. Has like no health. This is certainly going to be first blood. And there it is. Not even burning that flash. Catch, no, he was caught. And story of the season right there for Catch, unfortunately.
Now, here's the thing. They knew that KT was at their red because of the way that Arrow and Peekaboo came out of the topside jungle.
Yeah.
So why you would leave, why the top laner would leave and you would stay there when it's likely that Score is going to be coming back down, I mean, that's just terrible.
Yeah. I don't know. I have no idea. You give the blue buff right back to KT.
And now you're going to get
give him a kill.
Now you're just going to get tangled with at your own blue buff. As Score's just going to sit there. Oh, my.
Oh, yeah.
Geez.
He knows exactly where Catch is going to go.
Holy cow.
Again. He caught him one more time. Catch may want to try that flash now. There we go. Summoner out of the way. Gromp goes to Score.
I mean, that was a really smart play by Score. You have pressure in the bottom side. You're going to feel very comfortable about being a level up. You still have double buffs, and the Echo does not. Echo didn't even have enough money to go back and get a Trailblazer or anything. Not like it would have helped him in that little skirmish, but damn. Score just running a clinic already.
One of the most disastrous jungle starts I think we've seen for anyone so far this season.
It's pretty bad.
Yeah.
This is very poor decision-making from Catch this game. I mean, just get the blue buff and get out of there and don't just submit to endless pressure from Score. And the worst thing about this, too, for Spenu is that KT, we talked about their synergy with Peekaboo. I mean, now it's basically just deep wards for free the entire game. Okay, well
they're going to try to catch Sauce as well. Catch is right there, but it's not really going to help his mid laner. Saucin gets the stun off with
Peekaboo.
His W. Can they make a difference? Peekaboo coming down. They get the flash from Saucin. Can they cut him off? No, not quite. Score's still tracking him, though.
They don't have to stop. They're so low. They can just do this.
Yeah.
KT is 100% free to just do whatever they want in the enemy jungle right now. They force Saucin all the way back. They're going to make Saucin lose some CS, and the snowballing is getting pretty crazy for KT.
We're 5 minutes into the game, and it's a 1,000 gold advantage already for KT. That is not something you see very often in cases where it doesn't involve like a huge 5v5 level one fight.
Yeah, it's a really, really bad situation.
Wow.
That has been allowed to develop here. And to put salt in the wound, of course, that Azir, Nagne also coming up with a CS advantage in the mid lane, so Victor just goes back and gets boots. I mean, the recall timings are also just brutal for Spenu, because they can't even get good items on these recalls that they're getting. Catch is left with still without any kind of real jungle item, so that's going to affect his clear speed and his sustain on the clear. And then we also have Victor, who you don't want to buy boots first as Victor.
No, doesn't do you a lot of good.
Oh, man.
You can dodge the sand soldiers a little bit easier, but you won't be doing any damage.
No, you won't. And you won't have wave clear from your E upgrade either.
We've got to be careful. Like, Spenu is playing so badly that Monty's getting genuinely angry. I'm getting a little bit nervous sitting here. The rage bar is building. I can feel it.
That's when I turn into Mega Monty.
That's right. Yeah, we start like throwing the desk at people and stuff. The rage is real. Well, Arrow in secret trading some damage there. Well, mostly coming from Arrow. And this bottom lane, the dual lane, rather, for KT. Not really having much of a problem either. Score over the wall onto Sol. They're going to ult someday. Going to try to make a play. He's going to go under turret, taking some damage. Sol comes back in with the twist advance. Kill goes to score, and someday still makes it out. Another kill for KT, and this some frustration for Sol.
This matchup is so brutal.
Yeah.
It's a really bad matchup for Maokai, and we've seen it just so many kills in lane from the Fizz, and that makes getting into that late game carry state on Fizz where you can split push forever very, very simple. And especially for Score, he's on Rek'Sai, so he knows with his Tremor Sense that Catch isn't around there. They also had a ward in the Tri-Brush, and so there's just nothing that they could do. This Echo needs to farm right now, has finally his Chilling Smite there, but that's, I mean, Score just still scot-free, walking around, not worried about anything. He has the Sivir and the Eni in the jungle with him. He's going to take the red buff, has that timer from doing it in the first place. So yeah. Ketch going to try and answer with a buff of his own, but this is really dangerous. He doesn't actually have the timer on that, and Azir has pressure, and Fizz has kill potential right now, for sure.
I mean, I guess if you're Spenny, you've got to take some risks, right? But it's not looking too good. He's just going to leave the small Krug alone and
I don't even know what Ketch is doing. He also should know that there isn't any possibility that that red buff is up right now, because the red buff just spawned for KT. Mm-hmm. And he knows that Rek'Sai's jungle path was his red to KT's blue, and then he got harassed at his own blue and forced out, and KT took it. So there's not even a chance right there that the red buff's going to be up.
Oh, he didn't even check it. He just went and...
No, he walked around.
Cleared a little bit of stuff. Oh, did he? Okay.
Yeah.
I thought he walked around the other side.
I mean, okay, you get a little bit of counter jungling done, sure, but that's a lot of risk when this Azir and this Fizz are controlling your side of the map.
Score coming in. Is he going to find Ketch? There's a recall. Doesn't quite catch him in time, but he will come in behind Sol.
He didn't even see him because he wasn't moving.
I guess not. No. Sol, though, knows what's up. Spots Score coming through.
But now the blue buff going to be contested by KT. You can see Score already pinging the assist, and somebody's going to go back right now by take that Phage and then head up into that side. So here's another buff steal. Holy cow.
Just an easy handoff. It looks like they're playing on red side, man. It's like the easiest steal handoff I've ever seen.
Okay, Wolf's being taken by Ketch. Steal some more. There he goes. Takes the Wolf.
Oh, man. This is one of the most brutal
counter-juggling
performances I've seen in a long time.
Score's playing this really well, but
yeah,
it's also like pretty disastrous jungling from Ketch.
Yeah. Now, Peekaboo is even nearby then, because we did see the lanes swap for KT.
Yeah, why not translate this? You have a bunch of deep wards now. You can just take the dragon whenever you want, basically. Okay, Score's here again to take. Oh my.
Did he just get the
yes,
big raptor?
Yes, he did.
Wow.
This is, I can't even imagine how much suffering Ketch is going through right now. This is just, I mean, Score is just incredibly annoying. Now he's going to try and kill Sol under the turret.
Well, he's got the timers on absolutely everything right now in Spenu's jungle, so he can just keep doing this.
And Ketch doesn't have anything.
Someday with the ult again. Yep, they're going to just try to dive Sol under his turret. Worked once before. Someday taking a lot of damage, though. Going to get out with the playful Trickster. Unfortunately for him, Score takes the kill again, but hey, he'll take the assist. Why not?
And he knows where Ketch is all of the time, too.
Peekaboo has to be careful. Getting very low.
And out of range for another Bioarcane Barrage, looks like. But plays that a little.
Flash for it.
Could have flashed if he had to. No ults burned there or summoner spells burned by anybody. So nice calculation for Peekaboo, just getting back.
Yeah, Arrow's still farming just fine. CS staying even.
Score has all three kills this game.
Yes, he does. Yep.
I don't understand why Rek'Sai's don't just go Warrior Enchant when this happens. I think you should just go Warrior Enchant and just keep on ganking and just kill their jungler over and over and over again. You don't have to go Cinder Hulk. Just try and carry. All right, so going to try and take this dragon now. There's a ward there. That's going to be picked up by the Raptor buff from Score.
Yeah, it doesn't look like KT's too worried about it, though. Arrow's going to come down to help with the dragon, or come up rather. Pikabu just getting some vision in. Secret is there, so Spenu looks like they may want to try to contest that, but I think that would be pretty dangerous.
Well, somebody's waiting to TP right now. He's just sitting in the river. This is very dangerous.
Oh, here they go. Dragon taken by KT, scoring a little bit of trouble, gets exhausted, gets out there. And Spenu just milling about. Can KT turn onto this, possibly?
They really shouldn't fight right now. Nagne has control over the choke point. Victor just can't get in there.
Yeah.
So eventually, KT able just to push their way out, thanks to some cooldowns being used by Spenu, and get out of the pit.
Yeah, why not? Man, like a 40 CS lead now for Nagne in mid lane, too.
I mean, we typically see this matchup go in favor of Azir in the early parts of the laning phase.
Not this much, though. This is pretty extreme.
Well, it's also that KT knows that they have no jungle pressure. So basically, Nagne is free to play as aggressively as he wants because they always know where Ketch is, and Ketch is just not a threat due to his deficit and the level of control that Score has had over the course of this game and the number of buffs. The fact that Sasa didn't get a blue buff because it was taken. Mm-hmm. It's really rippling out to the entire game. But we've been talking a lot about Ketch, but to put it on Score, too. Score is snowballing this game beautifully off of that mistake.
Oh, yeah.
He definitely is making the most out of the advantage that he has managed to win.
Well, Catch is lurking down by the bot lane, but Arrow and Pikabu are pushed back. They don't look like they're going to be putting themselves in a position to be ganked anytime soon.
So the Rek'Sai ult sound went off, and Sol immediately walked between the two towers and put a sapling in that brush because he is so scared. He knows what's coming.
Yeah.
He knows when that ult sound goes down that Rek'Sai could be in his jungle at
Rek'Sai
any point.
Is coming to kill you.
Yeah.
Again.
Exactly. The ult is back up. The ignite is nearly back up. It's a major threat. Score going to take his third Spenu red buff of the game.
You mean all of the Spenu red buffs this
yes,
game?
Yes, all of them.
And they've gotten all except for one of the blue buffs, I believe.
No, they got all of them. Have taken every single one of Spenu's buffs this game.
You're right. And even the buff that Catch had, the KT blue buff, he only had for a short time until he died to Score. So they have taken every buff this game. Literally every buff. Wow.
Jeez.
So wait. So if there's a stun down onto Secret. A little bit of damage coming in. Pikabu getting aggressive, but they're just going to force him back in lane. So theoretically, if KT can win this with Spenu getting no kills, no dragons, no turrets, and no buffs, that would be like the most perfect game you could ever have. Denying even every buff.
That is actually true.
Yeah.
I don't even know if that has ever happened in a professional game before. That would be some pretty insane domination.
Yeah. I looked, they're going to take it again. Wow, it's actually something that could occur here. Ketch coming in, not getting it close enough to smite it. That would be amazing, man. That would be like the roughliest of raffle stops of all time. The most perfect game.
I don't know if KT can actually have the patience to do something like that, but maybe.
Hey, if I was on KT, I was like, wow, we've got a chance to do something that...
I don't think they even really have thought about that fact, actually.
Maybe they're kind of joking about it with each other. That's possible, but... Mid turret went down a little while ago. Wow, Secret takes more damage. Forced to pop his ultimate there. Walked right into that brush that Pikabu is sitting in.
Well, he knew the Tibbers and the Ignite and, of course, the Sivir ult were still up. You kind of do have to pop it there unless you want to just get burst down from that point forward.
Yeah, but, I mean, he should have known that, and he was in that brush too, though.
He didn't have a ward. He might have suspected it, but...
Might have thought he went back or something, I guess. But
yeah.
Kind of dangerous to walk into a brush with an Annie in the game like that, though.
All right, so the Scrying Orb goes down, and KT starts to move forward. They know that there was a recall from Nuclear and Secret. They want to get this last remaining outer turret that Spenu has. 15 minutes into this game, we're already with a 5,000 gold lead from KT Rolster, and here we go.
It's going to get even bigger as that bottom turret nearly goes down.
Yeah, it's going to be saved. I don't want to over-pursue at the moment. Trinity Force completed onto the Kog'Maw, so this is a very good timing for Kog'Maw to do something. We see Sasin just having to take home guard boots because he's been so pushed around in lane that he just needs to get back quickly to wave clear at this stage.
Yeah.
But that's going to be really hurting his damage.
Yeah, certainly. Dragging up in a minute 30 now. And so KT should be able to position themselves fairly well. Someday waiting. He's like, I need to get this red buff. Got to keep it away from Catch. Sol's gone down to the bot lane, though.
It'd be interesting to get a perfect game here because we haven't had one in Korea in a while. There was one in Demacia Cup in the finals last week. Game 3, EDG versus OMG was a perfect game from EDG. Obviously, a very dominating win. The game ended in, what, I think 24 minutes?
Well, that's how most perfect games end up going, yeah. And a big gank down in bot lane coming in for Spenu. They need to make something big happen here. I don't know if this is going to be it, though.
I don't know. Arrow is playing this very conservatively at the moment. Annie a bit split up. They may be able to do something here, actually. But
oh, boy.
Seoul is also now 3 levels below Someday and 50 CS behind.
A couple levels below Arrow as well, too. It's bad when your top laner is the same level as your opponent's team support. There's a flash, pulverize, and Peekaboo, no way he's getting out of that one. Well, there goes the perfect game. Arrow makes it out. But a very well-coordinated gank for Spenu.
I mean,
really wanted that one.
Yes, but they're going to lose so much for it.
Although you lose
here's
the dragon,
some more,
at least.
Here's some more XP.
Oh, nice knockup from Score.
Dive onto Someday.
Or.
They're going to get so much Tier 2 turret damage done in this particular situation. Now, Spenu is going to respond with a tower of their own, but you have to ask, was this worth 2.5 waves of experience that Seoul is going to get denied here when he desperately needs it? Was close enough to hit level 9, but they lost a Tier 2, and they may lose another one. Now, can they get a dragon? I admire Spenu. You have to do something drastic at this point if you
teleport.
Want to win.
Teleport coming in for Spenu. They really want to take this one. Dragon about half health. Seoul immediately just has to run away from lane. Score is right there. Catch manages to dodge the boomerang blade. Someday comes down too. Yeah, it doesn't look like KT wants to allow Spenu to have this dragon.
And Azir not even needed. Azir just keeps pushing up the mid lane. He knows Victor's not there. He's not needed in this little 4v4 engagement.
Yep,
he can just take
CS
the dragon and keep on rolling. Spenu, I guess they had to try something right there because if they kept trying to respond to KT's way of playing the game, they would have been denied. Looks like Nagne wants the red buff this time. Gonna give it to Someday for some extra split pushing power. Here comes Rek'Sai. They want to keep pushing this and keep denying the jungle as much as possible.
Well, KT seems to have all the advantages you might want in a game of League of Legends right now.
I think that you could say that, Doha.
Yep.
It's also, I mean, we look at this 5K gold lead, and it's not, I mean, it's a large margin this early into the game, but it's also the fact that Spenu has had to use their gold in very inefficient ways. I mean, we take a look at Sassen's build right now, not exactly ideal if you want to fight. No Righteous Glory on Seoul, and he just has magic resist, so Arrow will shred him.
Well, they want to make sure that they get no blue buffs. Oh, Secret coming in as well. Nagne getting very low, pushes people back with the Emperor's Divide. Meanwhile, a turret goes down. Who got the blue buff? Catch got it. Oh, they got a buff. Nagne escapes with his life, though.
Yeah, and just a quick disengage. Spenu popped the ult immediately onto Secret, and they are at least trying to get back into this game, Spenu.
Yeah.
I think that they were smart just to go ahead and get the global gold at the bottom side. They had to do something. It ended up being a bad trade for them because they lost a Tier 2 for a Tier 1 and just a kill onto the support, but they would have just bled out slowly had they stuck to standard lanes and tried to fight KT without doing anything sneaky whatsoever. That said, Seoul is still only level 9. Someday is level 12.
Wow.
Seoul cannot be anywhere near Someday or he will die.
Yeah, it's still one-sided. But, I mean, it is encouraging to see Spenu come up with, you know, plausibly good moves to get them little edges back into the game. But it just seems like it's already too far.
Yes. I think you are right,
Much
Doha.
Too far. Far too far, by far.
Well, and they're just waiting this one out right now. Sivir getting progressively stronger with this Infinity Edge and the Zeal. We see the Trinity Force now done onto Someday. It's really their time to shine. This is a great power spike for them to operate in.
Yeah.
And they can just keep pushing their advantage. And Someday, once he gets his TP back up, will have a great opportunity just to go wherever the hell he wants and start diving towers.
Yep, pretty much. All score coming in. Looks like they want to take this one of the tier twos, maybe mid, maybe bottom.
Yep, just close it out. You already have a strong split pusher. Dagne just playing a little bit defensively right there as Catch comes out to attempt to gank.
Yep, uses the ult, but better safe than sorry, I suppose. Oh, Peekaboo tried to go for the stun onto Secret, couldn't quite land it. Can build it up pretty easily again anyway. And now the pressure in the mid lane.
Soul just can't get near this minion wave.
Nope.
This is a total disaster.
Can't do anything. Wow. That has got to be one of the, for Soul and Catch, this has got to be one of the most frustrating games they've ever played.
Well, yeah, and a lot of it was Catch falling behind meant that Soul was pretty much dead to rights in a bad lane matchup as long as Score kept ganking, which of course he did. And somebody didn't get the kills, but he got enough gold and enough of an advantage to take control. He's about to pass the Flame Horizon at 22 minutes.
That's pretty fast. Meanwhile, Tier 2 goes down. KT taking another one. Only the Tier 2 in bot remaining. And a pretty clean closeout so far by KT.
This is a very textbook closure. I mean, it's only 3-1 in terms of kills.
Sadly.
I don't know. I like seeing it because this means that KT is just snowballing an incredible lead without actually taking any risks.
Couldn't they do it with maybe a few more tower dives or so? You know, can they throw a couple of those in there?
I mean, they could, but those are riskier than what they're doing, which is just methodically bullying people out of lane and then taking all the objectives.
Too bad.
It's too bad. Huh?
Oh, well.
It's all right. You can go cast the LPL next year, Della.
Well, you know, I like variety, so take some of these, take some of the high kill games. Need to have a little bit of both.
We're shipping you off to Sydney. Sorry.
Oh, no. I've never been there. I heard there are bears that drop from trees. Sounds terrifying. Papa Smithy barely escaped with his life, man. The stories that man tells.
That's right. We're sending you to old time prison next.
I watched Mad Max Fury Road, man. I know what it's like down there. I'm not sure I could survive. I'd be a little bit worried.
It's okay. You actually get to be in the Citadel when you're casting, so don't worry about the whole water situation.
Like if Morton Joe greets you at the airport. And, welcome to Australia. Like, oh no, they caught Score. Score could be in a little bit of trouble here. Flashes to try to get away. Burrows, he's okay. No problem. Not going to ride in Valhalla just yet. Although Rek'Sai with a chrome grill would look pretty fearsome, if I do say so myself.
Mad Max Rek'Sai skin.
That's right. Well, meanwhile, Arrow's just like, yeah, I'll push this lane. Sure. Why not?
I like how Score has a 100% kill contribution rate. He has all the kills. Taking all the kills on the
I'm trying
jungler.
To think of another game I saw. If it ends like this, where the jungler had all the kills, I don't think I've ever seen a game where the jungler had every single kill.
It's not going to end like this, Doa.
Probably not. There's got to be some big team fight.
I would love to see Score end this game with a pentakill for the ace on a Rex jungle Rek'Sai without any kind of damage whatsoever.
Hey, there was a pentakill with a Rek'Sai in LPL, wasn't there?
Was there?
I think there was a while back.
That would be hilarious. Third dragon.
Yeah. Another dragon.
KT really should just start baiting the Baron right now because of how much control they have over the top side of the map, considering all the turrets, inner and outer, are gone in mid and top side. So let's go for that now. Screw it.
Yeah, why not? So Pool Party Rek'Sai has a life jacket on. Yep.
Well, you need a life jacket when you swim in the ground. Did you know that?
Yeah, well, it makes sense because Rek'Sai is good at swimming, like tunneling through dirt and stuff like that. But if you put her in a pool, sinks like a stone. Like you can't swim at all with those like big forearms and like
but,
tiny legs. You can't really.
But Rek'Sai's not
well.
In a pool. Didn't your mom ever give you a life jacket for when you went out to the park?
But what if the river gets a little bit deep in certain places? You know, you kill the Baron and then you accidentally step into like the hole that he comes out of. Might need a life jacket there. It's dangerous. I don't know where the water's coming from right now, though. It's got Nami syndrome, you know? There's just, like, a lot of water around.
For no reason. Yeah. You're just getting everybody else wet as you splash them, as you...
What a jerk.
...swim by.
Wow. Annie's like trying to charge up her stun, and like Pool Party Rek'Sai comes by. It's like, thanks a lot, man. Now I have to start over again. That's four abilities, you know. Yep, that wouldn't be fun. Sivir's got to be really careful with those boomerangs near the rubber tube pool things for Rek'Sai.
I also don't understand that, because if there's an entrance with like a rubber tube, isn't Rek'Sai just going through a dry tunnel?
Yeah, you but he's I mean? Got the water that surrounds his body to help him slip through.
Okay. I mean, there's water in there, too.
Oh, yeah, that works. Well, it's like a slip and slide, right? I mean, you put a slip and slide on dry ground, and then you put water on it, and you can slide along. Really, that's what they should have had for Pool Party Rek'Sai, a slip and slide. She doesn't actually go underground. That's fun. Meanwhile, tier 2 went down a bot. It's like, oh, Flash Pulverize. They do catch Peekaboo. Peekaboo getting very low. Exhausted. Gets taken out by Victor Sassen. With a kill there. So Spenu finds a catch, but catch got caught. And will he be able to get out? Sivir ult popped someday on the side trying to flank. There's another kill for score, because why not? We're giving them all the score today. Oh, and Soul comes back in, still very low level, and there's Nagne finally with his first kill of the game.
Aww.
Score very upset with that one. Yep.
Well, that was a bit greedy from KT. They were trying to split push both top and bottom lanes simultaneously while invading the jungle. So Spenu sees this opportunity, just all ins, and gets another kill onto Peekaboo, who is not having a great KDA performance this game in spite of winning very handily so far.
Well, it's funny because, I mean, he's been there to help out in push lanes, but when it comes to team fights, he's kind of just gotten caught.
Well, Secret has been very good about comboing him so far and making sure that he goes down.
Well, I certainly wouldn't call this a bad game by Peekaboo or anything like that. I think he's playing just fine. I think he's just getting caught once in a while.
It's his shot calling that's leading to victory this time.
That's right.
Him and score.
Yep.
So, Frozen Art down for someday now. He will have a very easy time against this Kog'Maw. One other thing about this Fizz, it's a great pick for this game in particular, not only because of that lane matchup, but because Victor and Kog'Maw have a lot of problems escaping from a Fizz once he gets into a backline situation, and they don't have the best peel with this Alistar to help out with that.
I thought you were going to say it's because of the Pool Party Rek'Sai skin, but I guess I was wrong. My analysis needs work, apparently.
The Fizz pool party synergy is really high.
That's right. He is an aquatic creature himself. Well, KT moving into the jungle again. And Score just kind of hanging out. Are they going to try to pull that red buff back? Wow, this is like the biggest fight over red buff I've seen in a while. They did get the stun down onto Secret, but he backs away.
Oh,
wow,
huge
three-man
knockup
by Score. Takes a lot of damage, though, from Sassen coming back in there. They're going to go after Secret. Someday is right there. Meanwhile, a big Emperor's Divide pushes everybody into the waiting clutches of Someday, going after Catch. Going to get a kill there. Soul makes it out. Another kill for Score, though. What a huge game for Score. Wow.
And that was a really panic Chaos Storm drop by Sassen, because basically Score got the knockup and then was able to just to flash out right as the ult came in. And as soon as a lot of these key cooldowns were down, KT could just re-engage on a whim and take out the remaining members.
Oh, Peekaboo taking a lot of turret damage, but they should be able to push in here for an inhibitor now. Yeah, still enough time, and that inhibitor is going down so fast that they have no trouble at all taking that. And with the Baron buff, it's going to be annoying for Spenu to deal with it, and now no tier 2s remaining means they can just rotate into mid and take that turret too.
Yep, very methodical play. They don't want the inhibitor right now. They're just going to recall while everybody spawns, take the next dragon for number 4 in 40 seconds, grab any buffs that they can get on the way out. And so KT playing this game very, very methodically.
Yeah.
Looking strong. May have overstayed their welcome. Goodbye, Nagne.
Looking strong. Yeah.
Yeah, a little overcommitment for the blue buff right there, especially standing on the opposite side of the pit instead of in a place where they could take it a little bit more safely.
Yeah, so
positioning could have been better there, but Spenu does maybe manage to get a dragon here. 30 seconds left onto Nagne. Will be a 5v4. Probably still a fight that KT can win, honestly, with Baron buff.
If they choose to take it, we'll see. They've got some time until Nagne is up again, so he's not going to be a part of this one.
I'd just take it. Why not?
Oh, they're going to try. Let's see. Spenu going for the dragon.
Just waiting for Sivir.
Yep. Hanging out. Here she comes. Someday. looking like he wants to go in. Seeker with another nice engage here. They don't really catch him with the parallel convergence. Arrow kiting away, doing some damage. Soul gets a little bit too close. Takes a ton of hits here. Dragon still doing a lot of damage to Spenu. There goes Soul. Seeker comes back in, knocks away a score. They managed to take out Someday, though. A double kill, though, for Arrow. Double kill comes in. Triple kill comes in for Arrow. Peekaboo with the stun. That's a quadra kill for Arrow. Is he going to get the Penta? Nuclear getting very low. Trying to get one to Peekaboo. Penta
kill for Arrow. Second
of the
scene.
That's the second one. Wow. Well, Scuttle Crab. Scuttle Crab gets the Penta yet again. Ultimate Scuttle Crab. And I think that's going to be very close to the end of the game. I don't know if they can finish it right here. I don't think they can, but
Peekaboo set up that flank Tibbers so well.
He sure did.
And there are the super minions. Really nothing they can do right now, even with these short death timers. Oh, they're just going to back out, do the dragon, I guess. They want dragon number four. So not going to commit to this until they can actually push in with all five members.
Well, KT was missing a few people, so safer to do this, I suppose. Let's watch this pentakill yet again. Ooh, he had a special pentakill screen for that.
Secret actually did do a good job of trying to engage this fight. He actually has been playing well this game in spite of everything that's gone wrong for the team. Of course, Soul very low and kind of baited into this one. Secret comes back in, gets the fish on him, and gets finished off by Arrow as he comes through. Peekaboo, what a great flank.
Yeah.
And then he keeps on playing nuclear here, just trying to zone him out, and then they lock him up, stun, knock up, and very easy Penta for Arrow.
Not bad at all. Wow, well. So we're going to give Arrow another computer, I guess, or something?
Arrow, well, this is another nice bait that's going on here.
Oh,
Nagme,
yeah.
Not going to fall for it, though, even though the Talisman was popped. See Catch taking a lot of poke damage, and Sivirult coming through, score.
Yeah,
going to start corralling them. They're Secret's going for it.
Wow, they managed to jump onto Peekaboo right away. Secret's been doing such a good job of setting up some kills. Meanwhile, though, action in the base as Someday trying to end it right now. Arrow getting chased down by Catch, gets caught himself, though. Two more kills. Well, let's just give Arrow some more kills, huh? Sossin gets caught with that boomerang blade, and there's the surrender right before Sossin dies. Oh, no, they got the Nexus. Never mind.
It was not a surrender. It was
never
just
mind. That was
Someday.
Just Nexus dying. I didn't realize he was killing it so fast.
He has a Sheen, so he's going to get through that Nexus with all those super minions pretty quickly. Well,
Well, there you go.
Commanding win by KT Rolster, as expected. Didn't expect the level of dominance from minute one of that game, though.
Yeah, I mean, Spenu really got rocked very, very hard in the jungle early on, and to their credit, they came back and tried to find small opportunities to come back, but it was just way too much too fast for Spenusan.
Number three team yet. And I'm not saying it is KT, it's still early, and this game, of course, you really expect KT to do well in, but if they can take it out against Jhin Air, then they will have beat all the other teams that are 3-6, and then we can definitely say these guys are the ones who deserve that number three spot.
And after talking to Peekaboo today, that is definitely their goal as well, too. They want to definitely cement themselves as one of the top teams here. So here we go. Picks and bans for game number two. KT looking to close out a 2-0 victory over Spenu.
So Echo Ban. We have not had many of these, that is for sure. But that's such a priority jungler for a score. Now, they were able to take away in the first round of the draft on red side in the last game, but certainly KT would take the Echo in that same position if they are given the opportunity. So that is just not even going to be an option for a score in the next game.
So this is going to be interesting, too, because it seems like Spenu is trying to set things up for a Rek'Sai first pick. It seems like they want to just take that away for Catch, but Score could just play Evelynn, so I don't know if it's the biggest threat. Afraid of the Annie from Peekaboo as well, too.
At least if you take the Rek'Sai and he plays Evelynn, that you know that there's going to be some advantage that you have with that Tremor Sense. It does take away a little bit of Eve's power.
Do you take maybe the Sivir here instead?
No, I think you do take the Rek'Sai. I think you do take the Rek'Sai. After last game, you just need to give Catch some sort of advantage, because otherwise we may see a similar game where Score just walks all over him.
Well, first picking the Nidalee would be a bit of an odd idea. I think it will be the Rek'Sai in a moment. Ezreal's still up, though, too.
Sossin did carry that game against Samsung with that mid lane Ezreal.
Yeah. Rek'Sai is the safest pick, though. And a bit of trolling coming in from KT as well. They're like, all right.
You see Sasan just grinning right now on his screen.
He knows. He's like, yeah, I know. I played the Vel'Koz in this year.
I'm the dirty Vel'Koz picker.
Well, I think they're
right
go
here,
with the Ezreal.
I think KT should just take Ezreal. You can always flex it into an AD carry. Arrow is one of his most played champions is Ezreal. He's very comfortable on that pick. Take the Ezreal. Nogne has played it in the mid lane previously. So go ahead, grab it. Keep on moving with that pick in particular.
They are really rubbing that Vel'Koz thing into Sasan here. I wonder if they're just going to swap it over and grab the Azir and be like, bring it on.
No.
Okay. Not even the least little bit possible?
Maybe on the next patch. Actually, Vel'Koz might be better with some of the changes to Rylai's and Liandry's itemization. I'm curious about that one. Now, they banned the Rumble in the last game, so they will take it this time. So no real power picks actually going the way of KT besides that Rumble, just playing very conservatively and looking to counter their opponents in the draft. However, now that they have committed to the Rumble in the top lane, they don't have that many ways to shut down a potential Ezreal pick. Of course, the Maokai is definitely great at dealing with a mid lane Ezreal. Anything with that targeted crowd control does quite well.
Right. I mean, Yasuo would be able to block a lot of the skill shots coming in, too. And if Spinner's worried about it, they could pick it up. But it seems a bit premature to just blind pick the Yasuo, you know?
Well, you never know. Sometimes you are Anarchy, and you just blind pick Yasuo because you think there's a Runeglaive Ezreal coming in. And then the Runeglaive Ezreal goes into bottom lane, and Faker plays mid Aurelia against you instead, and you lose.
Yep, that does happen. They're going to go with Maokai Alistar instead, which is a much, much safer way to go. So fairly tanky team being built up by Spenu right now.
Yep, and they take the Maokai away. They're certainly building up to what we assume is going to be a Runeglaive Ezreal. This is a great team to play Runeglaive Ezreal with.
Yeah. Yeah, and that makes a lot of sense for a bot lane to go with that Runeglaive Ezreal. Janna, Kog'Maw, and Kog'Maw can, of course, shred through those tanks pretty quickly.
I'd be pretty worried if I was KT, because if you take the Janna here, you're really lacking a decisive engage onto a poke composition. Because if it's Corki and Ezreal right here, that could be very bad.
We'll see what Spenu decides to go with. There's a Corki. Well, there was a Corki for just a moment anyway. I don't think it's going to be Lulu Jinx.
It could be. Spenu does stuff like this. They definitely have played around with Lulu Jinx compositions in the past. Yeah, I think it's going to be Corki.
Yeah.
Nope. Now they're trading. Now they're just going to troll Arrow.
Yeah.
Just a little bit, but I'd feel pretty good about playing Corki and mid Ezreal into the composition that we're seeing from KT Rolster.
Yeah. Well, Sasan's a big Zed player, but I don't think we're going to see him go full tanky with the Assassin here.
You can't play Zed blind. That's crazy.
Yeah. Corki Ezreal. All right. Wow. All right. So some powerful poke coming out for Spenusonic Boom in game number two.
To be expected during meta composition. So what does KT have in store? Because if you're Spenu right now, you're not actually that worried. How are they going to kill the Ezreal? Sure, they can get a good Rumble equalizer onto your back line, but
Ahri, perhaps?
Maybe. I mean, they can't even really play Yasuo because they don't have any other knockups. Wow, that would be weird.
That seems very risky. I mean, I don't think Victor is going to be able to dodge those. I mean, he's got a little bit of, he's got the shield, but still.
I don't really get KT's draft this game. Yes, they banned the Rumble, and they're obviously concerned about Sol's Rumble heading into this. But at the same time, you know that Spenu likes to play mid Ezreal. I think you just take Ezreal or Maokai in the first round of the draft, and therefore you either have something to deal with it or you just have it.
Yeah. Weird. Oh, Azir, okay. Swapping it over at the last minute. Nope, swapping it back to Victor.
Indecisive. Nogne's just laughing right there. Just changing the pick at the very last second, so he feels confident that he's going to be able to bully out this Ezreal with the Victor in the early game. We've seen the Azir do very well against the Ezreal early also, just because he doesn't have a lot of tools to deal with the Sand Soldiers or really win a poke war.
Right.
Without, because just because of his itemization and the fact that he has to run Smite. So okay. KT, yep, they're going back to Kog'Maw. They've been playing a lot of Kog'Maw recently. They have a great composition for protecting Kog'Maw. Very high damage in the late game with Kog'Maw and Victor. But they need to be concerned about this Ezreal early, and they don't have a lot of kill pressure with Evelynn Victor in the mid lane. That is that is somewhat concerning.
That's what I was kind of thinking, too, is that they can't really, presumably, they can't really snowball that early lead as hard as they did in game number one.
Right, and they also don't have kill pressure in top or in bottom. They don't really, I guess Score is just going to be farming this game because he doesn't really have a good way to gank. He can only counter gank. Maybe if he's lucky, he can get a kill onto Ezreal because Ezreal is quite squishy, but Rumble against Maokai will be hard, and also Catch will be looking for those kills alongside the Maokai, onto the Rumble in top.
Yep. Well, we'll see if Spendusonic Boom can take a game and tie things up with a clever comp. Let's get in the game and find out. Welcome once again to Summoner's Rift. KT Rolster versus Spenusonic Boom. The crowd excited about the comp, excited about the game. And Spenu, yeah, good draft for them. They've come up with a really strong poke composition, very strong tanky front line to go along with it. But will it be enough? I mean, the thing is, you just never know if you're going to see what happened last game happen again. You know, Catch just sticking around to the jungle randomly, getting killed. I mean, there are certain X factors with the Spenu team that can throw off even the best draft.
That's true.
Yeah.
Spenu going to use Rek'Sai Q to clear the ward, and then just get some deep wards in, checking all three camps on the red side of the map, so they'll know if Score starts anywhere in that vicinity.
Yeah, makes sense. Meanwhile, some wards going down for Spenu as well, or Score as well, or KT as well. I don't know what's going on anymore. What game is this?
It is the League of Legends.
Welcome to League of Kart Racer.
Might as well be in Korea, you know?
Right. Wouldn't be the first time. Oh, look at those drawings.
KT players making faces.
Oh, with like a bread or a marshmallow or something. I don't know what that was. Either way, it makes me want to eat s'mores now.
Do you miss s'mores?
I like them. They're good. It's a good campfire.
I'm trying to think of if I've ever seen marshmallows or graham crackers in Korea.
Yeah, I don't think I have either.
I think they're probably marshmallows, but I would not put a lot of hopes on graham crackers.
There's definitely marshmallows, but yeah. Might have to search for the graham crackers. Peekaboo coming down.
Being a jerk.
Be a little bit annoying, yeah. Doing a lot of damage to Soul, actually. He's got to be careful, though. Oh, Peekaboo. He gets exhausted. He is actually just going to flash and possibly die. Arrow coming in. They pop that summoner heal to try to save
Rumble
him.
Is here.
Whirlwind saves it. Yeah, they could turn around on this one someday. Oh, he misses his harpoon after the flash over the wall. What in the world is going on in this game?
Saving Private Peekaboo.
I guess so.
Inside the enemy jungle, not respecting the Twisted Advance or the red buff. Having to use all of his summoners and also two of his allies summoners.
I don't know why Peekaboo stuck around, man. After the whirlwind, you just get out of there. But he's like, no, I've got this, man. If I shield myself, no, I'm not level two. But if I had level two and I could shield myself, my auto attack would do so much damage.
Yeah, that was problematic. I don't know what Peekaboo's doing today. He's had a couple of questionable calls either. I mean, he was targeted very heavily by Spenu on their engages in the last game, but still some positioning errors. And that was definitely an overcommitment. You're not playing Nautilus there, buddy. You can't really just do that.
I will tell you what it is. It is a lesson that we, humanity, can learn from, is that revenge poisons, Monty. He got targeted so hard in game number one, he's like, you know what, I'm just going to come into the jungle and be annoying for as long as possible.
He stayed
too long. The rage was too high.
You do realize you are talking to a person who ideas Monte Cristo about revenge poisons. Right?
See, I think you need to learn this more than anyone then.
What? No, that's the whole point of the book, Doa.
Oh, well, there you go. I haven't read that in a long time, I guess. I
That's I'm going to go with ever.
He fights the big whale, right? It's like, oh, score being annoying, too. Catch is trying to catch him. He does get him with a knockup, double knockup. The secret comes in there, but once again, someday comes to save the day. Which is kind of an awkward sentence, I guess, if you say it like that, but whatever.
You know, that's the whole problem with the really terrible Hollywood versions of The Count of Monte Cristo that have been done.
I haven't watched those.
Because the latest movie was just absolutely awful at the end because it's like he just lives happily ever after and gets back together with the woman he was supposed to marry. Well, no, that doesn't happen in the book. He realizes that he's made horrible decisions and that he's spent his entire life either in prison or trying to get revenge, and that he's wasted his existence.
Yeah,
so he just sails away, just leaves. He just says, peace out, and goes away.
He should have just let that whale go. And then he was so mad about that big white whale that it poisoned him.
Yes, my name is not Ahab. By
Ahab.
The way.
Ahab Cristo.
So it's also not call me Ahab, but whatever.
It's call me Ishmael, but, you know, whatever. We've gone so far off the rails at this point. It really doesn't matter.
Well, you got me talking about how bad the Hollywood remakes of the movie versions of The Count of Monte Cristo are, Noah.
Well, that one started. It was the best of times. It was the worst of times.
Yes, like, that's exactly. Nailed it.
Every English major is just like, they've turned off the stream by this point.
No, it's okay because I'm here. I'm saving them, though.
Oh, okay. All right. Defender of the classics. My favorite part of A Tale of Two Cities was when Goku showed up and went Super Saiyan, and then it was the best of times. But it was a long time because it took like half an hour.
Oh, it took way more than half an hour.
Well,
probably took like 13 episodes.
Just the transformation took half an hour. The build-up took like about 60 episodes or so. Yeah, well,
I can't believe that people actually watch Dragon Ball Z. It can be condensed down into 5 episodes, maybe.
Yeah, probably. Oh, here comes Catch. Wow. Oh, who's going after who now, Score? Score on the run. Catch being a bit more annoying on this Rek'Sai, and overall not a bad start for Spenu, but a little bit of a sloppy start for KT as well.
Yeah, they're just trying to. I think that they want to just keep up the jungle snowballing. That's why we're seeing such heavy jungle invading and such heavy jungle pressure. They saw how Spenu came completely unglued under those circumstances in the last match, but they also don't have that same crazy advantage that Score managed to acquire, so they're getting pushed out just a little bit harder. Spenu definitely playing around it relatively well.
Evelyn Janna aren't exactly the best high-pressure jungle invade team on the planet.
I mean, they're okay. Yeah, they're definitely not the best, though. That is true.
Oh, get out of here. That's Secret's Tri-Brush.
Secret's Pink Ward.
Not anymore. Now it's gold for Arrow. Food for Kog'Maw.
I like the reindeer, you know, Kog'Maw.
We've got multiple Christmas skins here, Sol and Arrow.
They're hoping for a gift of a victory.
I guess so, yeah. KT might do that. Uh-oh.
Oh, wow.
Equalizer does not hit. They get the slow from the smite, though. Score still chasing. Someday just totally whiffed that Equalizer.
Yeah. Wasn't the best Equalizer, but you really have a low percentage of making that gank when the Maokai's flash is up. So they got the flash anyway.
Well, that Equalizer is going to be back a lot sooner than the flash is, so they can certainly try it again.
Yeah, it does give them some time just to go back right there. Blue buff, actually, being taken, and Nagne's gonna smell this. Catches just by himself right there.
Oh boy, Chilling Smite used, but here comes Nagne with a lot of damage. Exhaust, Secret trying to save the day, but the damage comes in, and first blood goes to Arrow.
You can't just invade with no vision and try and take a buff away when the mid laner is totally free and your mid laner is in base. That is not a thing you can do safely.
I think Catch really needs to seriously consider changing his name. I don't know, man. This idea is not working out for him.
You know, it's interesting because Catch actually was looking a bit better in the Samsung match, but this has not been his day. That said, KT has been playing him like a fiddle. I mean, they just keep figuring out where he is and taking away all of his tools that he needs to succeed. So it's hard to look good in this situation when the entire team is playing to destroy you.
Yep.
But he's not exactly helping himself either.
Well, he's taking way more risks than you would need to. say the least. More lane pressure coming in. Arrow a little bit behind in CS right now, but probably not the biggest concern.
I don't know about that. This is a matchup he probably should be winning.
Well, there's been so much action in the jungle, though, that he's missed a lot of lane time.
Yeah, he also got first blood, so he's going to be fine.
Oh, yeah, that helps. And first blood's pretty good.
I hear it's a pretty okay thing to get.
It's pretty not bad.
400 gold.
Not bad, yeah. You can buy another Adorn's item. Oh, oops. Oh, catch.
He ended up taking the blue buff, actually, the Equalizer. So Equalizer nearly actually coming through.
Yeah.
So interesting play by Someday. Just going for some blue buff pressure. How many times do you see a Rumble walk into the jungle and drop Equalizer on the second blue buff spawn?
Oh, KT really knows where to hit Spenny. That's for sure.
Just slamming him in the jungle right now. Yeah. I never see that.
Rumble in the jungle. Who knew? That's a term that's never been used before.
Not by anyone, not even once.
No.
Over many years and different sports and esports.
Never.
Never is the name of a skin in the game. Isn't that coconut skin called Rumble in the Jungle?
Oh, is it? I don't know. I thought you meant never was the name of the skin. I haven't heard that one either.
Oh, I doubt you would have heard that one.
Well, I mean, the coconut one, it's not really a jungle. It's more like a island kind of thing, tropical island sort of thing. So it's more like island-oriented than jungle-oriented, I suppose.
I don't even know what it's called. I don't even care.
I have no idea. It's probably just Pool Party Rumble.
I wish it was being played this game instead of that super annoying Super Galaxy Rumble skin.
Everybody loves it, though.
Why does everybody love it?
I don't know. Because it's not like these guys have seen Gurren Lagann, probably. So I have no idea.
A lot of the pro players in Korea watch anime.
They're all... I suppose it's not as old as I thought it was.
I mean, I haven't seen it, but whatever. All right, catches here. He sees Score.
Isn't that the one where they fight the giant whale?
I have no idea.
Okay, Score gets caught. Yeah, they're going to go in. It pops his ult anyway. Is anyone coming to save him? There's the flash.
Ghost Nagne is here to save people.
That's right. No, man, that is a real live Nagne, and he is dangerous. Soul taken out by Nagne.
All right, that was pretty clever, though. I got to hand that one to you.
Much more dangerous than a Ghost Nagne.
Ghost Nagne haunting the studio at Yongsan here in Korea.
He haunts the jungle of Spenu as well.
He haunted the forest that game. That's pretty severe.
Oh, it's true. This is Nagne's haunted forest. Oh, Peekaboo. Again, being focused, going to flash away. Arrow there with a lot of damage to try to save him. Peekaboo coming back in. He hasn't had enough yet. Wow, Secret taking a lot of hits. There's a slow.
He doesn't have level 6 yet. He cannot damage.
Yeah, I don't think so. Arrow turning onto Nuclear now. Man, Arrow just like a one-man wrecking crew there.
Meanwhile, Nagne is just pushing the lane and then walking to top and bottom repeatedly. Yeah. Look at the warding, too, from KT. They've gotten so many wards into the enemy jungle. They have three in the pink wards in the river, too. So it's just a total blackout. Basically, Spenu can't get wards into the river at the moment. They can't actually get into the enemy jungle without being seen. Well, they have four pink wards in the river. Okay. Sassen's going to take one of them.
Oh, well. They can replace it. It's only 100 gold.
Arrow behind in terms of that CS, but still doing work. And we're going to have to wait and see what Spenu does on this power spike. Once they get some more items onto the Runeglaive Ezreal and get that Trinity Force, they'll be in prime position to start pushing.
And we know Sassen's really good on this Runeglaive Ezreal, too. So the damage could start to come fast and furious. Or at least once every cooldown for Two-Shot Barrage.
Might as well be fast and furious.
True. For Riot, it's a little bit too fast, too furious. Got a nerf. Oh, Peekaboo's still low, but they're going to go after Secret. He does have his ult now, though, so.
Yeah, so does Peekaboo.
Oh, Peekaboo! Oh, stuck around a little bit too long. Nice snipe by Sassen. No emotion. He's like, yes, he deserved death.
That was actually pretty predictable, honestly. Peekaboo is just not having the best day today. I have to say he's playing a little bit fast and loose.
I agree. Oh well. I mean, you play a lot of those tanky champions, and then you switch to something like Janna, and you try to like move up and be as aggressive in your positioning. You're like, oh yeah, I have no survivability at all.
I'm just bad at that. Oh. Well, little scuffle.
Yeah.
So I'm going to try and finish this one off. Did have a nice equalizer that time, getting some quality auto attacks down, but it's just not going to be enough damage to kill the tree.
Not quite, but it will be when Nogne comes in. Yep, there's the Chaos Storm goes down. Soul flashes, flash from Nogne for the damage. Soul comes back in just to kind of hang out. Soul's still alive. Goodbye. Two-shot barrage, not connecting. Well, it might hit someday, actually.
It did not hit someday. Someday was down next to the turret, but it will be some more damage. Another death to Soul as KT's game plan of focus, catch, and Soul and remove them from the game continues just as it did in the last one.
Yep. Helps quite a bit. A really good game so far for KT.
I mean, they're only up 300 gold, you might say, but they've been controlling this game pretty effectively. So now that we saw the back from Victor, Spinner going to take a very nice timing here to go ahead and grab the first dragon of the game.
Yeah, Score probably has to let this one go, not even trying it. Pickaboo wanted to try something, though. Of course. 1v4 to steal the dragon. Sounds like something Jonna can do.
More damage on to Score with that Rune Glaive. Nogne getting a big chunk out of Sasin.
Yeah. That True Shot Barrage is starting to clear waves very quickly, though.
Yeah, not as fast as Nogne can. He still has some nice wave clear, some better wave clear in that mid lane for a little bit. Once the Ludens comes through, that may change just a tad.
Well, more lane pressure for KT. Now that Dragon's gone, they can really start moving into the jungle and just kind of taking control of the rest of the map. Ah, they want the blue buff. And they should get it, unless Sasin, no True Shot Barrage at the moment, so he can't really try for a steal.
Yeah, KT just fighting around this rumble, too. They know who's strong at this juncture of the game.
Yep.
On this side of the map, and Victor getting quite fed. So they just want to keep playing that top side. Doesn't really matter if they give up bottom right now. Arrow will come into his own eventually.
Yeah, there's no real big rush. KT can really kind of just play this one slowly and wait for the late game, can't they?
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah.
Obviously, the Runeglaive Ezreal is going to be strong in the late game too, but Spenu could just itemize for MR against Korkiez and no problem late game. So.
Oh, they'll get their first turn of the game here in bot lane. Nogne, though, still doing a lot of decent chip damage to the mid lane turret.
Up, Sasin gets caught out.
Wow, that damage from True Shot Barrage, though. Man, he knew it was coming.
Well, he got a full combo down on the score. Yeah. Q, W, and the True Shot Barrage. So Sasin not going to be caught out. Score didn't pop his ultimate. All he did was use the Chilling Smite. See if they can get that damage, but he just face-checked a True Shot Barrage.
Point-blank True Shot Barrage definitely helps out quite a bit. Score too low to really participate in this. Yeah, Spenu putting some pretty good pressure on.
Yeah, I'm not sure they're actually going to be able to capitalize on this, though, with the Victor still under the turret. Oh, they're going to try and dive, actually.
Yeah,
smart call.
Nice knock up on the Nogne. Seeker comes in as well. Nuclear finishes that one off, but here comes the Equalizer. Someday coming down. He's on his own a little bit. Soul pops that ultimate. Now everyone on Spenu chasing Flash from the wall from Samsung. They're going to turn around. I mean, Someday, not Samsung. Someday gets a kill there. Randomly throwing things in there. Oh, True Shot Barrage does not kill Pickaboo this time.
Not yet, at least. So I like the idea of the dive there from Spenu.
Yeah.
Secret's been good in the last couple of games about initiating the few successful fights that Spenu has had. And it's worth it if they can get some more damage on this tower, because by killing Victor, they destroyed the primary wave clear force of KT, and they traded Victor for a support, which is kind of whatever. That's definitely in the favor of Spenu, and they got some damage done on the tier one. So it wasn't an overwhelming trade, but it was a good one. Okay, well, looks like Arrow being doubly cautious, dropping the ward in after checking it with his R.
He really had a good feeling that Nuclear was in there, and he was, so.
It was an accurate feeling, to be sure.
Yep. Detecting some radiation, I guess. A bit of a lull as KT comes back to lanes. Looks like Someday is able to push some pretty decent minions down to the top lane. Baron up in a minute, but I don't think we're going to see that taken anytime soon.
No.
Probably not.
be pretty dangerous. KT wants to drag this one out for sure.
Oh, yeah, definitely. And I mean, this Runeglaive Ezreal is going to be obscenely powerful in the late game, but overall, KT should be stronger, right? Maokai is going to be really tanky, too, though. I don't know.
Well, they have the damage deal with Maokai. I mean, they have a Kog'Maw. You're going to be fine against the Maokai.
True.
And it's just, again, it's about the efficiency of an Aegis here and the efficiency of MR for KT. Interesting build that Someday has going on right now. Not sure what he's doing.
Like early death cap, I guess? I don't know. Haunting guys into probably, well.
He could go Void Staff just for pure MR to try and deal with Soul, but that's kind of awkward. You definitely want an Abyssal if you're on Someday this game.
Could be building into Zonia's, too. I mean, he could turn that Tome into
It's kind of hard to tell what he's doing at the moment.
I don't know. Just getting a lot of AP. He's like, just getting a collection of all the pure AP small items right now. Pretty nice.
Stack it up early.
Yep. Oh. Peekaboo has found you. Or have you found him? Spinner doing a pretty good job of warding this bottom jungle in anticipation of the dragon coming up. In 40 seconds or so. And they really want to make a play on Sasan. They're going to do a lot of damage. There we go. And they just blow him up right before dragon comes out. That is really good for KT.
Well, they knew that he didn't have his flash up, so he just had that short-range ability, and so they just chase him down. And Nagne didn't even have to blow a summoner to get that. And when he has that ghost up, he's going to be able to chase the Ezreal with some efficiency. I mean, obviously the targeted CC is still going to be better, and I don't wholly agree with KT's draft, but just getting on top of Ezreal has to be the goal, and they punish Spenu for grouping late and being alone where they can just make the pick in the mid lane with that heavy, heavy Victor burst.
Yeah.
And then possibly translate this into a dragon, but nobody's on it yet, and there's no vision there for KT.
Well, KT's recalling right now, too, so they may just be giving this one up. Again, you know, they can play for the super late game, but they can't give all the dragons to Spenu. The first two is about all you can really afford if you're going to do that.
Yeah, you can give away three. It's fine.
A bit risky.
Can't give away this tower, though. No, that is a bit more difficult to deal with. As now Victor has to overextend without a lot of mobility.
Spenny is just going to move right down and take the dragon, too, and it looks like KT is just going to give it to them.
Yep.
Yeah, Spenny's played out their composition pretty well so far.
Weird. Someday went for Deathcap Sorcery Elixir.
Which seems like something you'd want to do if you're about to fight a big dragon fight. But
yeah, it does seem like that. I agree, Doa.
Huh. But then they didn't. All right.
Not sure what's up with that itemization. Here we go. Blue buff will be taken. Sasan may try for a snipe here with a true shot. He will go for it.
Oh, very close. Oh,
nice try.
Yeah. Now, Sasan's really good with those true shot barrages. His Ezreal was spectacular when we saw him play it last time, and it's looking good today too.
Well, see what KT can do. They're about to be in the most dangerous part of the game for them once that Echo is completed, the Luden's Echo, because that's where Spenu is going to have a very good chance to fight them. Soul may finally be getting a Righteous Glory to help with some of these engages, but this is a scary time, and you know, score is not, nobody's building an Aegis yet. They are a long, long way away from an Aegis. Score has been putting down a lot of time just harassing the enemy, which has caused him to fall behind in CS as Ketch has mostly just been farming his own jungle.
Very true. KT coming in to put some damage onto this bottom turret. Ooh, score looking for an opportunity there, but not quite finding it. And no dragon to take. So they're just going to have to go for the lanes, and Nagne has done a great job of just slowly pushing down that mid lane. Oh, maybe some action down in the jungle here. Secret with the two-man knock-up score and Peekaboo chasing, though. There's a knock-up onto Secret. Catch there as well, too, but he's got to be careful. Arrow running away, taking some damage early on, but here comes Nagne. So KT turning this one around. They use the Evelyn ult. Score going on to Nuclear Secret. Very low true shot barrage. Takes a big chunk out of Nagne, but they manage to take down Secret anyway. A kill for Arrow. And KT really wants this bottom tier one turret now.
Yeah, and they just baited out the Alistar ultimate until it was used, and then just re-engage, burst the rest of the Alistar down, and they pick up a kill. Both top laners coming in with TP, but it was into the lane. so they couldn't get to that fight in the river in time. Someday still has his ultimate available should he want to drop that equalizer. Some low members, of course, Peekaboo on the side of KT Rolster. They still want to keep pushing this up, though. Score looking to get some vision down in the enemy jungle is going to be seen by the Tremor Sense running through that Tri-Brush, but KT keeps the heat on, and they're going to take a bottom turret.
Looking that way, and so that's all three outer turrets down. KT takes the turret lead, takes the gold lead, despite being down two dragons. Oh, he was attempting to kill Peekaboo. Oh, he nearly did. Wow.
That's going to work someday.
It will. He's tried that a couple times, and it's come very close.
It nearly worked in the last game. Yeah. That was very exciting when he tried to do that. The Sasin special.
Yep. Trying to time that recall. Very cool. Got to defend that top turret now.
All right, looks like finally Aegis might be coming in for score as they move up with this very large minion wave, try and keep Nuclear and Secret off it. You know, Spenu rotated up very early. That was actually really smart of them. So when they saw how many people were on the bottom side and they knew they couldn't defend it, they just moved Nuclear and Secret up to the top side and said, screw it, we have a large minion wave developing. We're just going to try and trade for this instead. And they nearly succeeded in that end. But Spenu really looking about a minute in advance there and just trying to give it up to KT. Now, you could argue that maybe you don't want to give it up at that point in time because you're in your power spike. You are the team that wants to fight right now. And trading objectives is actually beneficial to KT in the long run, but they had already lost Secret, so they couldn't do much.
Well, the funny thing is KT's been winning the fights so far. And they've got to be really careful. I mean, if Arrow goes unopposed, that's a lot of damage that can come in.
Yeah, huge.
Yeah. Nagane as well has done a good job of coming in at the very end and just blowing people up. Kushab Raj coming through, takes a chunk out of Arrow. There goes the turret. And KT going to back off. Oh, never mind. They're actually going to go in. Wow, trying to catch. Nuclear gets exhausted, going to be able to Valkyrie away and avoid that whirlwind.
Yeah, they're afraid. Nagne's had the priority on every single one of these roams.
Yep.
He's no longer dominating in terms of CS as a result, but he's having a huge effect on the outcome of this game by trying to push people off. They still lose the tower, but they're able just to run people away for the time being. Dragon going to be up in a minute. This is something that I think KT would want to fight. Someday, no longer has that Sorcery Elixir, now just going to be building into the Void Staff. One would think he would need a Zonya's or an Abyssal Scepter for defense, but I guess he just wants to get one round of cooldowns out and then die.
He's just going all out, man. Yeah, okay. Nagne still over 10 CS a minute right now. 273 at 26 minutes into the game.
Yeah, Zossid matching him, so yeah. He's in a good position.
Absolutely. And so, KT looking to take this next dragon. Spenu's gotten the first two, so they really do need to take this one a bit more seriously. Like you mentioned earlier, three dragons is about all you can afford to give, and if you can only give them two, that's even better.
But they have the setup already.
Yeah, pretty good position.
They have the crab going to Spenu, and they're going to lose some pink wards right now because basically KT was fanned out in the river defending the chokes, and there's no real mid lane tower pressure to go with right now. Spenu has to get this dragon, I think. If they don't get it, I'm not sure they're going to be able to kind of close this game out because they need a timer. Otherwise, KT will just play passively until they hit the six item phase.
Yeah. Well, KT would get a nice decent damage boost as well. Well, score could be in a little bit of trouble here. Gets knocked back. Secret taking a lot of damage from Nagne, though. Nuclear poking. Score, I think he got a little bit lucky there. Dragon activated. We'll see if KT can take it. Fans are excited about something.
Excited about dragon leashing. Aren't you? Don't you just want to get up and wave your hands about in the air and
I love it.
Cheer?
I want to do like a front flip off the desk, man. I'm so excited about this dragon.
I want to see you do a front flip off the desk. Will you do that later?
I'll learn how to do a front flip and then I'll get back to you on that.
You promise you're going to learn how to do a front flip?
No, not at all.
I'm just looking for ways to get you killed, though.
Well, I'm glad we've got that out in the open now. You know, I've suspected for a few years.
Oh, now I'm on record.
I'm glad it's on tape. Yep. If I disappear tonight, guys, you know who did it.
It was Doa front flipping.
Sorry, whoa, they're going to go in with the Righteous Glory. There's Equalizer all over Spenu. Nagne getting knocked up, getting pushed back into the fight, though. And Spenu looking really good in this one. A lot of damage coming in from Nagne, though, before he went down. KT might be able to turn it around, but Sasan firing a lot from the outside. And it looks like that's going to be a one fight for Spenu here.
Yeah, but they're all so low that I'm not sure they're going to take the dragon. But fortunately, Sol does have his TP up, so he can come right back over to that objective. Ketch has the Void Rush too. So Spenu is going to take the red buff for Sasan now and start to get priority over that objective again.
I bet Azonius would have been really nice for someday that fight.
I don't know what this build is for someday. It's not good for this situation. It definitely is subpar.
Well, Spenu will get the dragon too, so that's three dragons for them now. Certainly making this one a bit of a contest.
And I love how Spenu is so convincing, and they're so aggressive in their engages. They saw someday on the flank. They immediately just went all in with the glory and the Alistar Maokai combination to pick off someday. Someday is very vulnerable with this build.
Yeah,
the death cap is not good here.
They got Nagne too.
They don't need more damage. They have Kog'Maw Victor. What they need is a front line. And considering Score is not even building, I don't even know why they're not building an Aegis this game. This is really very poor itemization from KT.
Yeah. Yeah, it looks a bit cocky, doesn't it?
It's possible that Peekaboo will build an Aegis, but sometimes Janna players do like to get that item.
I mean, he's still got to finish Talisman first, presumably, so it's a long way away.
Hey, if you don't have Peel for the Victor and for the Kog'Maw here, this composition doesn't work. And the only way you get Peel is if you have Azonias or additional tankiness onto the Rumble, and you have tankiness onto the Evelynn too, neither of which have really come to pass quite yet.
Very odd. We'll see what Spenu has in store now.
I mean, this is the problem, though, is we've seen Spenu play well up until this point in the game on multiple occasions. We even saw them doing it against SKT.
Yeah, true.
But they eventually just make a fatal error. They will make one very glaring error then lose to these top-tier teams.
I mean, that's kind of the story of a lot of these weaker teams, though, is that, you know, you can play just for the late game and wait for them to mess up.
Okay, I guess what someday thinks he's doing, because he has another Sorcery Elixir right now, is I think he believes that if he can get a great ultimate onto Corki and Ezreal and he can just kill them immediately with the burst from him and Victor, that there is no more damage on Spenu, and then they can just clean up the fight after that, which is true. Arrow should be able to play Janitor at that point pretty easily.
Or at least get them low enough that they have to back off and you can kind of scatter the team. So, all right, there's a logic behind it, certainly.
But I think it's too much of a risk and is too reliant on you completely outplaying your opponent. And considering that Sasan is the best player on Spenu, I don't know if I would kind of have that much faith in outplaying him in particular.
Yeah, both Sasan and Nuclear looking really good this game. And Secret's been making plays all night so far.
Yeah, Secret's been fine.
Yeah.
Spenu maybe slowly getting it together.
Yeah, a little bit too late for this year, but maybe next year. Who knows?
Maybe next year.
Yeah. Got to start somewhere. I mean, there's a little organization called MVP that had a couple teams that eventually became Samsung Blue and White, or Blue and Ozone.
And those teams were not good, by the way, guys. I know
you
like
awful
to remember them. This is here's a funny thing. You know, I read people's comments, and they say things like, well, you know, Korea lost all these players. How could they be good anymore? How are the players good? And that's true. I mean, definitely the talent exodus did hurt Korea as a region. Oop, there we go. Attempt to blue steel. Not going to quite work. Does get a couple nice chunks out of people. But, I can say, well, Samsung Blue in 2014, which was the most dominant team in Korea over the course of the year, because Samsung White never even won champions, and Blue made it to back-to-back finals and won one of them.
Yeah.
And beat and beat Samsung White in a best of five in two consecutive seasons. But when I'm like, well, where was Samsung Blue the year before that? There's rising talent in this region for sure. We look at guys like Chaser this year compared to last year, and it's a huge difference. But Blue in 2013 was not good. You remember that game where Faker went nuts on LeBlanc? You know which team that was? That was MVP Blue with Easy Hoon in mid lane, and it contained Deft and Acorn and Heart.
Yeah, the MVP teams, which later became the Samsung Keys, were easily some of the worst in the league in 2013.
Well, Ozone White was good then, but
yeah,
they had already won a season of champions. But Blue had a...
Late 2012 and very early 2013, too. They were pretty rough.
Yeah,
so basically the moral of the story is that just because a team like Spenu is pretty terrible this year doesn't mean they will always be terrible.
Right, they can really get it together next year.
Certainly can. I mean, with talent like Sassen and Nuclear, I think they're looking good. I mean, if Secret can start to play like this consistently, I think they need to replace their jungler, but they're not doing bad as a team. Well, Score getting a bit caught. Nuclear going for another kill. There they force a flash out of Score. Oh, Sassen catches him with the True Shot Barrage. That's what I'm talking about, man.
Sassen has been very dangerous on this Runeglaive Ezreal.
You cannot give him this.
KT has not given themselves very good tools to deal with it.
Yeah.
Unfortunately for them, that's just how it is. And they're not playing very impressively this game because it is so hard to get onto the back line with this composition. Score's dead. Spenu should definitely start this Baron.
They will. Someday, remember, he has a lot of damage on this Rumble, but they should see this coming. A good equalizer could make things tough. Oh, flash knock up onto Someday. Gets pushed back, and no Zonias, no life. Gets the equalizer down at the very end, but not before Soul gets in the back line onto Nagne. Pikaboo chunked out as well. True Shot Barrage nearly taking out another couple people on KT. And Spenu can't do the Baron, but they get a kill onto Someday.
Someday's Rumble is doing absolutely nothing. Now, if he could actually just stand there with his Zonias and a Flame Spitter and zone them out for 2 seconds, that would be an entirely different story. But he's just incapable of doing that with this build that is not suited to this situation whatsoever.
Wow, and now they get fourth Dragon.
Yeah, Spenu playing this out pretty darn well.
Yeah.
Gold lead still close. KT can still definitely come back in this one, but...
And there is also that factor that we talked about, too, where there is that kind of that late-game mistake possibility that's a distinct possibility for Spenu.
I mean, usually would have happened by now, so Spenu actually lasting longer in the battle against themselves.
They're getting better. Certainly getting better. True Shot Barrage going through again. Man, Sassen just taking huge chunks of people.
Okay, well, Deathcap's done now, so that'll be huge for Sassen against a team that still doesn't have an Aegis for whatever reason. I have no idea why KT would not build an Aegis.
You know, no Zonias on Someday, no Aegis on Score or Pikaboo. It's really, really weird. Pikaboo doesn't even have his Talisman done yet.
I don't know what they're doing. No, this is a very poor performance from KT, I feel. They are not reading this composition from Spenu or respecting it at all. Meanwhile, Someday's going to get chunked out by Sassen because he has no Abyssal Scepter. But it's okay, because he has a Sorcery Elixir.
It just looks so sloppy, you know?
Just looks thoughtless to me.
Yeah.
Oh, is it going to work? Is it going to work? Oh.
Nope.
One of these days.
Someday wasn't low enough anyway, but...
The Sassen Surprise.
That's right. No one suspects the Sassen Surprise. Sassen is just becoming this roaming death machine right now.
Yeah, this is how they beat Samsung just the other day. You know that he can play the Ezreal.
Gave it to him anyway.
And you didn't put pressure on him really in the mid lane. You killed him once. All right, here comes the Sorcery Elixir. He's going in.
Oh. No, he's not.
Probably smart.
Yeah, it'd be a little bit dangerous. Oh, Arrow's still getting fairly farmed. He hasn't died yet this game. Ooh, Spenu, though, going after this Baron, and it is dying so fast. Score coming in. They see him with the pink ward, though. There's some wards from KT. Are they going to try to seal it? Score comes in, gets knocked back. Baron taken by Spenu. Nice play by Secret just to keep Score from coming in.
Well, Score had no flash, so he wasn't going to do anything anyway.
Oh, yeah, you're right. Well,
they actually, that was a mistake. They should not have gone out of the pit right there because they should have had the flash timer from Score.
Well, I guess it happens to the best of us.
No, it's might is better safe than sorry, right? You still
exactly.
have your unbreakable will up. You're still going to be okay no matter what happens. And now, Spenu pushing forward. And Yeah, this is a really important match for KT to win 2-0. Having a point buffer and not losing a point to Spenu might be the difference between their playoffs and nothing, really.
This was not the time to get lazy.
No.
Or complacent. And their hubris may cost them a playoff spot.
It may. And still looks like the last item on Nagne is actually going to be a Lich Bane. Instead of a Zonya's Hourglass, which may help him survive some of this damage that's coming through, because he's been getting blown up pretty quickly too. And if the Maokai grabs him, he's not got a lot that he can do.
Looks like Someday's finally going for a Zonya's. 39 minutes into the game, probably a good idea to get that started. But Score's just getting a Banshee
Tail. So. It's actually a Luden's Echo.
Yeah, it don't scare me like that, man. Peekaboo, though, finally has a locket, so at least somebody has an Aegis now.
Holy cow, that took so long to complete. They're...
Yeah.
I mean, in spite of all this, in spite of everything that Spendu has done, they are only up 4K gold, which is a minor miracle for KT Rollster that they haven't been falling behind even further considering how this game has played out.
Oh, man.
And Arrow does have a Blade of the Ruined King, so he can actually heal that up.
Still, though, that's a lot of damage.
Yes. Well, welcome to the magic of Runeglaive Ezreal.
League of Runeglaive.
No, it's just one champion. Just Runeglaive Ezreal.
League of Smite. How about that?
Smite's for everybody.
It's a different game entirely, but...
With the nerfs to Skirmisher Sabers, we have seen Smites falling off in the top lane, though. That's no longer as prevalent as it once was. But in the end, Spenu is going to siege down the Tier 2.
And a minute 30 until that fifth dragon for Spenu, so KT really needs to make something happen now.
For KT, the Baron buffs from Spenu will be gone by that time. So at least they have that going for them, but they're still staring at a Baron contest that's going to have a lot of issues. They don't have a front line still. Score has a Banshee's Veil at least for now, but no armor if he actually gets an auto attack range of the Corki. And that's about it. And still no, we can talk about this, still no Zonya's onto the Rumble. Hello, Arrow. Heal off of some wards.
I love watching these two-shot Rajas. It's got to be terrifying for a Kog'Maw in this game. It's like, I still haven't died. But so close, so many times. Spenu certainly showing up.
On the most broken champion in the game.
Easy to show up on that.
Well, especially when KT knows they play it and doesn't have really any solutions in the draft.
Yeah, there's no other explanation for this from KT other than just like complacency, laziness, sloppiness. That's about it.
Yep.
Lots of other negative words that end with ness.
Well, probably will end in sadness for them.
Could be.
Uh-oh.
Oh, Score is in a bit of trouble.
It's okay. He's got his W.
Are you sure?
Yep.
Are you sure it's okay? Here comes Catch. They get the flash. There's the flash. Knockup. True Shot Barrage comes through. Oh, boy.
And no one was there to try and punish Spenu. Now, they do have to use the Alistar ultimate, but Score down at this crucial fifth dragon.
A teleport came down from Someday. He has to flash to get away, looking for a good equalizer. Doesn't find it.
I mean, they have to fight this.
Yeah. They can't let them have a fifth dragon. Losing Score, though, is going to make it very tough.
All right. I guess they're just going to give up dragon number 5.
Or are they? Here they come in. Nagne trying to seal it. Sasan manages to get it. Soul right on top of him. Goodbye, Nagne. Another kill for Sasan. Now, Spenu, with that fifth dragon now, is on track to win a game against probably the toughest opponent they've won a game against this season.
Definitely the toughest opponent. This would be a pretty large upset in terms of the game, but KT really didn't help themselves in this one. But Spenu just playing aggressively, getting the picks in the mid game, and now they have these 5 dragons, and there's just no wave clear now that Victor is dead. That was probably the worst choice KT could have made.
Yeah, true enough. There goes the inhibitor. Arrow trying to poke as much as he can, going deep, though. And they can't really do much about this. Score back alive, but without Nagne. Someday coming in. No equalizer to use anymore. Oh, True Shot Barrage.
Now, it sounds crazy to say, but we actually have seen KT come back from worse situations.
It's possible. It's always possible with these two teams, I would say.
KT did win a game where they had lost all three inhibitors at both Nexus turrets.
Poor IM. That was IM, wasn't it?
Yes.
Yeah, poor IM. Oh, man.
But it did take some pretty heroic play from Nagne to turn that one around.
Yeah. Well, Someday finally has his Zhonya's.
Oh, goody gumdrops.
Oh, happy. Someday. Well, for Spenu, today is special day.
I guess it is. Most likely going to take a win off of KT. Now, they didn't have good side wave control there, so they can't take much besides this mid lane inhibitor, but at least they have that going into Baron. And by the time Baron spawns, it looks like they will still have the dragon buff. So that is quite helpful for them.
Yeah, should have that for a little while longer at least. And right now, just putting all that pressure onto the tier 2. Need to be careful not to get poked out too hard by Arrow. Doesn't look like it's a big concern yet. Score lurking in the jungle underneath the lane. Wave clear is still pretty good for KT. Baron up in 15 seconds. Oh, Shot Barrage goes through again. Wow, welcome back in Italy, Spears. We've missed you.
Well, you can see Evelynn trying to get a flank, but they have a pink ward in a very good location. And if you watch the minimap, basically Secret was just playing defense against Evelynn flanks.
Yep.
On the top side, they didn't have any concerns about that. So nicely played by Secret,
and
not even giving
score. Back off and go for Baron, and yep, I don't think KT can stop them.
Oh, I wouldn't fight a Baron when they have five dragon stacks.
Nope. There we go. So second Baron taken by Spenu. Did I just say that? Second Baron taken by Spenu. Wow.
And that's the thing about this Runeglaive Corki is he is extremely strong in certain situations. Right.
Corki, wow.
Runeglaive Ezreal, yeah. In certain situations, he's incredibly strong. The situations where you can't get back onto him. He is very low HP and squishy and easy to deal with if you can. But KT, they even banned Ezreal in the first game because they didn't want to deal with this. And then they just randomly pick Rumble instead of Maokai. I don't know what to say. This is just, it was a very poor draft from KT.
Yeah.
Against a threat that they knew was there and were afraid of.
Well, the draft and the game looked a bit face roll from these guys. Arrow getting a bit low. So be careful here, and that's why. Ooh, close call. Manages to dodge it. They don't save their turret, though, and that's going to be another inhibitor taken by Spenu.
Going for number two, just a methodical victory.
Two inhibitors now rotating up into the top lane to try to take the third after they go through the enemy jungle. This time it's a 10k gold lead, but still, at this point in the game, pretty much everybody's got the items that they're looking for, so the gold lead isn't as important anymore. Well, I did not expect this match to be a bloodbath. A back-and-forth bloodbath. I thought this is what we were going to see in our second match today. I did not think this is what we were going to see in our first one.
Especially after game one, never would have guessed. But
I think
game one lulled KT into a very stupid false sense of security.
I think so, too. Oh, boy.
But you know what, Doa?
What?
When Runeglaive Ezreal exists, you can never allow yourself to be lulled into a false sense of security.
That's
he nearly killed Nuclear, but that's it.
Secret comes back in. There's a kill on Inagne. Now Secret picking up one via some damage from the rest of his team. Well, the only option here, Pikaboo just needs to build a death cap. Oh, Someday. Jumped on by Soul. Drops that equalizer. Gets very, very low, though. There's the Zhonya's. KT trying to turn this one around. Nice big knockup from Secret, though. Ult from Pikaboo looks good, though. But, man, Spenu's just way too powerful. Sasan nearly took down Pikaboo, but Arrow blocked a shot there. And that should be the end of the game. I don't think they can stop Spenu from killing these turrets now. They're going to try. Catch a bit low, but he's the only one that really needs to worry right now.
Holy cow. Arrow just getting hugely chunked out. There's just no tools left. Oh, the inhibitor respawns, but that's only
going to
deny
anyway.
Another wave. There's the Void Rush coming in from Catch.
Yep, that's right. No big deal. And Spenu looking to close it out. And somehow, some way, taking a win in game number two against KT Rolster. Wow, GG.
Well, that's that a very big win for Spenu. KT's certainly the best team they've managed to defeat. They still haven't won a best of three this season, but they take their second consecutive best of three to at least three games, which we can say is an improvement.
Well, this is one of the biggest upset single games I think we've seen this season so far, and if Spenny wins the match, that will by far be the biggest upset we've
seen
in a while.
Oh, yes, for sure. I mean, it was up there with, you know, Anarchy and taking a game off of SKT. That was a bit surprising, too. But this one comes around, and KT has to buckle down and get it together for this third game, because them losing to Spenu would be a disaster in terms of their playoff hopes.
Yeah. And we'll see who bans the Ezreal first.
Well, they probably just won't ban the Ezreal this time. They will just pick properly against it. If they had a Maokai, I mean, we've seen that SK Telecom with Maokai and Ryze has been able to easily shut down Ryze players,
I suppose.
They were trying to play this weird kite composition where they just got poked to death. Hmm. So same bans this game from Spenu. We're keeping the same sides for this one, Echo and Thresh. And Ezreal, what a great ban.
I think that's a pretty good ban. He's pretty strong right now with that Rune Glaive item that he can buy.
That he can with the Smite.
Use the Glaive of Runes.
So that means they're not going to get a Gragas or a Ryze ban. Although, why would you even ban Gragas in the last one? It's not like you were super concerned about Ketch's abilities.
Yeah, I don't think any jungle ban's really worth it against Spender right now, honestly.
So what'll it be, Gragas or Ryze? If KT is smart, they will ban Ryze because Sol actually did have a good performance on Ryze. And not the Gragas, because KT will still guaranteed get a good jungler in that situation.
You know, I think it's smart for Spenu to be focusing Peekaboo in their bans as well. They're going to ban the Rumble, all right?
I quit, though.
All right, goodbye. I'll solo cast it. Wouldn't be the first time. And they grab the Ryze, yeah.
I don't understand the priority on Rumble this match. It's not like Sol has had some earth-shattering Rumble games this season. He's had some Rumble games. They were thoroughly average. And that was it. So Someday came in with some very poor Rumble itemization in the last game. Now they have to deal with the Ryze, which is another ticking time bomb like the Runeglaive Ezreal. They're going to take away the Gragas. I think taking away the Alistar is super smart.
Yeah, I mean, Peekaboo's been focused pretty heavily in bans and pretty heavily in the game, too, this whole time. So giving him Alistar is going to make him feel a bit better, I would imagine.
Also, they were very reliant on Secret's Alistar engages in these games, which
very
he was
true.
Pulling off, even in game one that they lost. Even when they were getting wrecked in game one, he was still doing good work on that champion. And you could see that if they weren't behind, he would actually be making a very big difference. And he certainly showed up in game two.
That does give Rek'Sai over to catch again, but I don't think they're too worried about that. So what do you grab here? Support here? Keep things as hidden as you can for as long as you can.
It just depends on if you actually want to have that Ryze top. You can save it as a bit of a surprise, where you're going to put it, but AD carry is probably safer here. Take the Sivir with the Ryze. That's actually kind of important for you to have.
Yeah, because I mean, if you give your opponent Sivir to go with that Alistar, that's pretty dangerous. Yeah, there we go. Okay. Azir for Sazen.
Well, this shows their hand a bit. So now we know definitively that the Ryze is going into the top lane no matter what. But what does KT have in his champion pool? We saw them first pick Azir in the first game, and they decided to take Victor into the Ezreal in the last game. But Victor does have some problems against Azir in the laning phase.
Well, Arrow played a fairly solid game on Kog'Maw last time around. Had some CSing issues, but he didn't get killed a whole lot.
No, got the first blood in the last game,
too.
So we could see a very similar composition from KT. Not really sure you need to take the Victor now. I was going to say, take the Maokai right now. Mm-hmm. They have a huge front line to deal with Spenu, and Spenu still lacks any kind of engage here.
Yeah, it's looking like a really good protect the Kog comp, and maybe add a bit more poke into that as well, too.
So how does Spenu engage in these fights? They kind of need Sivir so that Ryze has another movement ability. If it's not a mid lane Ryze, he's not going to have that ghost to catch up to people to land that first big rune prison. So they're kind of pigeonholed into taking the Sivir here, which isn't going to be very good against the Kog'Maw in lane.
Yeah, I mean, it still seems like it'd be the most useful later on in the game, though. Maybe another lane swap, perhaps?
Yeah, you could lane swap here, but arguably that would set the Ryze up for some pretty devastating denial or possible dives in the early game. Hmm. So they're going to go for the Corki instead. Okay, so they're not even going to try and engage. Basically, this is a kite composition that Spenu has just pivoted to with Janna Corki. But they are not going to have any engage. Any. Besides either an Azir ult initiation or a flash Ryze W or a flash unburrow, none of these are great engages except for the Azir ult.
Now, if you're KT, what if you just take Sivir here and put Kog'Maw in the mid lane?
You would be a little bit worried about ramp time, and Kog'Maw's going to get denied a lot early thanks to the Sand Soldiers farming. So, it's possible. It's possible to do something like that, but I'm not sure that is going to be the way of things. Korea hasn't been playing AP Cog in a really long time. Still gets played in the LCS regions, but doesn't really get played in Korea.
Yeah.
The Victor is just another high-damage champion. They can try the composition they failed to operate properly last game, except now they actually have a front line. They don't have a Janna anymore. They don't have a Rumble anymore. And they have that disruption from the Gragas. I mean, this is a very strong, very meta composition that they've managed to put together for themselves. Much different than last game, where their first round of the draft consisted of Rumble and Evelynn, neither of which are really very high-priority picks.
Yeah, it looks really good. So Spenu has the ability to kite, but can they stop the siege from KT? Can they get the siege going themselves?
Well, they basically have to win by convincing KT that KT wants to engage on them, but I mean, they've got, KT also has good poke. They're going to be matching the poke with Kog'Maw and Victor that Azir and Corki can put out. So, I don't know, I think KT's just going to win a poke war, and then Spenu's never going to be able to engage on them.
It really does seem like Spenu's just going to get sieged to death this game. We'll see, though. Stranger things have happened. Hey, I mean, KT even won a game, or lost a game against Spenu once. I heard about that.
Yeah.
Shocking. Very surprising. Yeah. Well, there's our rosters for our final game in our first best of three. Didn't think we'd get here between KT and Spenu Sonic Boom, but KT a bit sloppy today. Spenu Sonic Boom looking really good. So it's time to go into game three and see who can take it. A crucial game for KT. Spenu with the opportunity here to play a pretty major spoiler potentially in terms of playoff implications.
Yes, that could be absolutely huge if Spenu takes down KT in this game three. That may well keep KT out of the playoffs. We'll have to wait and see if that's the case.
Well, we will find out as the fans chow down the pizza. We're going to chow down on some good League of Legends. It's time to get in the game and see who takes it. All right. Welcome to Summoner's Rift. Spenu Sonic Boom versus KT Rollster in our third game of the day so far, and KT sweating a little bit, and they will be even if they win this one, because not getting the game scores from the 2-0 could be a really big deal.
Yeah, we'll have to keep track of that and see how it unfolds. It may mean nothing. Especially if they can keep on winning best of threes, but if they have a little bit of a dry spell and somebody is able to catch up to them in that third place position, they are going to maybe have some pretty big issues.
Certainly could. Ah, yes. Pizza for everyone.
Pizza from Kespa.
That's right. Yes, they love Kespa pizza. It's good. Rave reviews. Well, looks like we do have the lane swap. Coming in from KT, actually. So we'll see how much they can deny this Ryze from Sol. Oops. Nope, just kidding. He's building things up.
He's just building up his passive.
His timing was so far off. He did it 20 seconds early.
Calm down there, Doa. It's fine. He's going to get those Q stacks going. There he goes. Going to get Another one.
Oh, boy. How exciting.
For the leash. So Alistair coming in early here. Freeze will be done by Arrow and by Nuclear in the bottom side.
Now, Secret got himself, or Peekaboo got himself killed doing that on Janna last game. We'll see if Secret fares much better.
He did die.
Oh, he did. Oh, yeah, that's right. He didn't die. Got himself nearly dead.
Now, just trying to be as annoying as possible, Secret here. Getting some good damage out.
Oh, wow. Yeah. Knockups here. Damage on the score. Two flashes already taken by Spenusonic Boom.
Yeah, the problem is that what's the sacrifice for that? Are Someday and Score really going to need those flashes? They also burned the Ignite. So, yes, they slowed down the jungling. That's nice, but it comes at a cost. And the cost is that probably that freeze is now messed up in the bottom side. Mm. So we'll have to check and see how that freeze does. In the meantime, Someday can just teleport right back into lane and see if he did not get the blue buff. But he's going to have an easier time farming now as a result of that.
A Secret actually going back early on to pick up a little bit more.
So that maneuver, you know, Doa, it looks good. But Someday now actually going to be ahead of Nuclear in levels and experience because he was able just to get the heal up and get back down into the bottom side so early. He's picking up a lot of CS too.
Yeah, he is.
As Score goes to take the red buff, but it did slow down Score just a tad bit. Hmm. Double jungling still going on for Spenu as Peekaboo sticks around in top. Looks like this siege is actually going to be broken here. Seems like KT is now starting to push forward. They have a cannon minion that goes down, but they've got some good denial on Seoul so far, even though this wave has built up pretty significantly, and that means Secret is there in the top side to help out, make sure that Seoul can farm some of this up under the turret.
They shouldn't have too much of a hard time doing that.
We'll take some poke from the Bioarcane Barrage, though. That's kind of unavoidable.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, gets a good amount of CS, though. Farms quite well so far.
Yeah, so it all ends up being about even in the end, minus those flashes and ignites, and just seems pretty unlikely that we're going to get much in this game going before those summoners are back up once more. Score trying to take the very safe route, smiting the wolves. Catch taking a look through the topside jungle. Maybe he can make a play from behind here, but those are not the players that don't have flash.
Yeah, I don't think that's going to work out. Yep. Catch just going back into river for now.
Yeah, with Score back, you don't want to play too aggressively. Instead, just right. Wait for him to come over to your side where you're going to feel a little bit safer. Proceed from there.
Wow. Someday. Forcing Nuclear.
Yep.
Pretty far back here.
Yeah, he really got control of this lane early, partially because of Spenu's actions. Missed the cannon, though.
Oh, that hurts. Bummer. Well, Maokai certainly did, Christmas Maokai certainly did receive the gifts last game, so somebody's going to try it out himself this time around.
The gifts were put under the tree by KT for Spenu.
Pretty much. Or the tree puts the gifts under him with that skin. That's scary. Catch might come in, but Score's right there. Gonna get spotted with that Tremor Sense, obviously.
Still not really a fight that they can take at this point in time. Nuclear is too chunked out to actually play aggressively. You just gotta know, Nuclear just gets out of there immediately with the Valkyrie. Doesn't want anything bad to befall him.
Yep, wow, Peekaboo getting really chunked down by this Ryze along with Secret's Janna. Ignite was used too, so just really trying to push him out of lane.
Look at the difference. Recall. Look at the difference between the CS between Nuclear and Arrow. That's really the big story right here, is because even though the top laners ended up even, Someday all by himself in the bottom side was able to put so much pressure down onto Nuclear that he forced him pretty convincingly off of the waves. And also lost some CS when they did that invade. And now the flash is almost there again. So I mean, Someday is doing a really good job of denying the Corki, which in turn is going to delay his power spike, and that means Arrow may get the Trinity Force first in the end. But it is a bit of a race, of course. Seoul going to be scary on this Ryze, if he can ever get in range to do damage. That's the thing with KT, is that how is this Ryze actually going to engage onto anybody who doesn't want to be engaged on, i.e. is a tank like Maokai or Alistar or Gragas.
So you really think it's whoever gets the siege started first is going to have a big edge?
I just think, well, I think KT has a much more versatile composition in as much as they can match the poke from Spenu coming in both mid and the AD carry position, but there's just no engage on Spenu. There's none. Unless Sossin gets some sort of insane ult engage where Ryze can actually get in close to the carries. How is this Ryze, especially without Ghost, especially without Sivir Ultimate, ever supposed to deal damage to Victor or Kog'Maw? It just won't happen. He will never be in range. Because if he starts to get in range, well, there's an explosive cask, there's a twisted advance, there's a headbutt. Just not going to get there.
Now Spenu trying to steal this blue buff. We'll see if they get to. Doesn't look... Oh, yeah, they did get it. They did.
Catch got it with the smite.
Wow. Spenu certainly putting the hurt on that blue buff. Nagne suffering a bit for that. Up in top lane, though, Arrow continues to get lots of farm, but Nuclear's kind of maintained the gap right now. He hasn't really fallen behind anymore since the last time we mentioned it.
All right, here we go. A few people in the mid lane. They're just trying to make their way over to the enemy blue buff to attempt to contest it because they do have damage there, and Sol is still trying to scale with that tier. Probably not the best time to fight with this Ryze. Especially since Kog'Maw already has a Phage.
Yeah, it's a bit risky. Blue buff getting very,
ooh,
very low. Sossin did get it. Huh.
So Spenu manages to kite out the blue buff long enough that KT cannot contest it in time. So they get two blues, denying Nagne. Nicely played by Spenu.
Yeah.
They're definitely playing better tonight than we've seen them play. I mean, the first game accepted, but that was a very weird situation that occurred in the first game that was punished very hard by KT.
Yeah. Yeah, things have tightened up quite a bit since then for Spenu Sonic Boom. And yeah, they're looking really good.
Well, let's not go crazy, dog.
Well, they're looking really good compared to how they've looked before. Well, catch coming in, a Peekaboo. There's a Rune Prison. Peekaboo tries to get out right away, uses that exhaust. He'll make it. They had to burn the summoner heal there.
Yeah, no flash used, actually, by either Arrow or Peekaboo. Somebody immediately gets onto Nuclear, unknowing that there's no jungle help coming for him. And so he can just close the gap and start bouncing him around with that Arcane Smash.
Mm-hmm. And I'll be curious to see if Sossin can make the plays on this Azir, too. We've seen what Coco can do on Azir. We might see it again in our next match of the night, but...
I'm still not a fan of relying on that as your main form of initiation.
Yeah, it's definitely risky.
I think Coco's Azir is amazing.
And if you can do it, you can do it.
I still don't believe that that is a good idea if you want a consistent way to open team fights.
We'll tell that to Coco.
Maybe I will. Be
Maybe
like, Coco.
Should.
Make somebody else on your team play an initiator.
You've got your opportunity here. Coming up right after this game, you can go into the booth and tell him.
Just go up to Coach Sun. Hey, stop relying on Azir for your primary initiation.
I mean, he's really good at it and has done it a lot, but no more.
Someday it will backfire.
It makes you worry too much.
It does.
Your heart rate just goes up.
I know. I get unnecessary spikes in my blood pressure from watching CJ games.
See, you like, well, that's most CJ fans, but like, you let things get a little bit too much under your skin, the excitement, you know? You like things very technical, very strategic, very boring.
Mm-hmm.
Just because you can't handle the hype, huh?
You mean exciting strategically? They're not boring.
Exciting strategically means boring. It's synonymous. If you look up strategically exciting in the dictionary, it'll...
Just like our game one where there were three kills for KT for forever in that game, yet they were still getting more and more and more of a gold lead.
Yep, not fun to watch. Not too exciting for me.
It was. It was a great to watch score.
Hey, man, whatever. Whatever floats your Rek'Sai.
There's no pool party Rek'Sai in this game.
It's true, but the memories are still fresh.
Catch plays boring normal Rek'Sai.
Oh, not even Eternium Rek'Sai.
Whatever.
Sad.
I think that's going to... Is it Battlecast Rek'Sai? Is it Eternium Rek'Sai?
It's Eternium, yeah. Battlecast is like the metal kind of stuff. Eternium is like the red glowing sort of stuff.
Whatever, they look exactly the same to me, Doa.
See, I was an art major. I've got an eye for this, these design type things.
But you do not have the words to accurately describe it.
I got enough, apparently.
No, because I still don't know the difference.
What am I supposed to say? It's like
red glowy stuff,
black and shiny, and yeah. If you looked at it, you get the idea.
I see. Uh-oh.
Oh.
Soul is very gankable by this Maokai Gragas combo. He could just straight up die at any time.
He's got a flash, so he might be able to get out of the first one.
Maybe. Nogne's coming up.
Operation Kill Soul.
Here we go.
Operation Soul Destroy. Oh, it's failed already.
Oh. Wow. Soul really playing with range nicely.
Yeah.
Reading the telegraph of somebody's walking up into that minion wave, so they're not actually going to get that chance.
Well, this gives Spenu a chance to clear out the vision, too, by a dragon. Wow, Secret taking some damage. I feel like KT could have set up an easier dragon than a big elaborate gank on top there.
Well, I mean, it's still going to be a risk as long as nobody's actually been pushed out in the bottom side to go for a dragon that early. But as long as they have maintained position on dragon because Spenu lacks engage, then they're going to be fine.
Well, KT coming back down now. Spenu did get 5 dragons against him last game. I don't think KT Rolster wants that to happen again.
Nogne finally getting a blue buff this game, was denied his first one. So Peekaboo will just recall. Head back and
Somebody comes back in with the Twist Advance, pushes Soul towards the turret. Looks like he'll be able to get out with that. Sustain the tankiness.
I
almost got excited about a top lane fight for a moment there. Oh, Catch. Catch could stop this.
Graceseeker?
Yep.
There we go. Nicely done. Catch is trying to delay him as long as possible, so he's going to lose CS on this turret and or force a teleport. But can he actually TP into this? He's got to be really nervous about TPing in while Soul and Catch are just standing there.
I don't think you'd want to do that, yeah. Meanwhile, Nogne gets some decent damage done to the Tier 1 in mid, and they're just going to take this Tier 1 in top lane.
Yep, that was a great play. Catches delay, and the fact that he was committing to going for the turret means that, I mean, Peekaboo actually does get some time here to allow Nogne to get a few autos, but they just basically take the tower for free and zone someday off that make him too nervous. Now, they can go for the dragon right now.
I think they should.
Oh, maybe not. Void Rush is there. The teleport also still ready for Rise, but I think you have to try and make a play under the dragon. And they're just going to back off. So Gragas went in, took the red buff instead. Looks like KT playing very passively this game.
Yeah, looking a bit scared. This is not what we expected at all from this match. That's for sure.
Well, I think they're just playing safe. They know that if they just play conservatively, eventually Spenu is going to make a mistake compared to them.
I'm just surprised they needed to in the first place.
Well, they still are waiting for their timings, right? They don't have to go in right now. The Maokai could use a Righteous Glory here, some more tankiness. They're still waiting on that Trinity Force. There's reasons to hold back. Don't need to go in swinging right from level 1.
Sure. Oh, Catch is going to go for Dragon.
They know this is happening.
Yeah, they do. I guess they're just going to allow it.
I mean, they could literally just teleport Maokai there.
They have to have their camera on Dragon to see it's happening, though. You can't tell if this is happening from the minimap.
Yeah, no one actually is looking at this. Yeah. They're finally pinging it. It's too late.
Oh, wow. Sneaky Dragon from Catch.
Wow, that's...
For once, Catch was not caught.
That is pretty bad from KT, that you actually have eyes on that objective and no one is checking it. You have to assume that there can be a Rek'Sai coming over the wall. Score just wants to go into the jungle. Looks like he didn't get the red buff earlier, like I thought. He went back and got his, just was doing some standard counter jungling. Here we go.
Yeah, on to Peekaboo. Nuclear takes a lot of damage, though. Score zoning people out. Secret pushing everybody back, but it pushes people towards Nuclear. Arrow can't quite get him, though.
First blood
goes to Nogne.
Nice.
Meanwhile, there's a double kill for Nogne after that. He comes down, makes a difference, and now they're trying to go after Catch.
As using the Chaos Storm for some zoning, Nogne can just run straight out with a speed boost from his Q. Soul just didn't show up to that fight.
Yeah.
Neither did Someday. So no teleports, but Nogne with a great Ghost Roam. Down to the bottom side to pick up the double kill and comes over the wall. Really nice flash play from Score on the body slam. So that's two kills over to Victor.
That is definitely not what Sossen wants to see in his lane, but Catch getting a lot of damage done to the mid lane turret, actually, in all this. In fact, he may just get it. He will get it.
Wow, Catch has been playing really well around turret pressure this game. If he's going to get two towers like this for free, that is absolutely huge. Now he could... Oh, Secret's going to get it, but this might... No, not going to be a fight.
Nice whirlwind.
KT doesn't have the Chaos Storm back up yet to follow up on that kill.
Huh. So that's a two-turret lead and a one-dragon lead already for Spenusonic Boom. A little bit of a gold lead as well. Pickaboo getting some deep wards in. Taking out some Rek'Sai tunnels. So gotta be careful, though. Nuclear's right there. Yeah, that's a lot of damage on the Pickaboo. Ouch.
Well, he's got some sustain. So, does know where the pink wards are. Gets information about a lot of members. Now, somebody's gonna get caught.
Yeah, Soul trying to do that, going in with the Rune Prison yet again. Someday, Twisted Advance over to the Raptors to get out of range. Nagne was coming up, so that may have just ended up being a trade anyway if Someday wouldn't have been able to escape.
Ryze powering up, though. He's got the Rod of Ages, and no one has been able to punish him yet. He's starting to come away with a nice, healthy gold lead against the Maokai as Someday has fewer and fewer ways to deal with him. Has to go for a Cowl just to stay in the 1v1.
Wow.
Score wants to make a play, but they do get seen via warding in the Tribe Rush. Now they're trying to push very hard right now. Arrow does have a Vamp Scepter up on his opponents.
Well, looks like KT is going to be able to take almost take a turret. Catch comes in with his ultimate, though. They're going to chase. There's a knock up onto Pickaboo. There's a stun. No flash for Pickaboo. He's in a lot of trouble right now. Has to use that ultimate to get away.
Interesting that Arrow would face tank that tower.
Not the best idea, maybe. Really wanted to get it. And can they defend this one now? Looks like they can. It's still got quite a bit of health left, so should be okay.
Yeah, Arrow back up too. At least he has the Vamp Scepter, so just waits patiently for the wave to come to him, then takes it out so that he is not under so much threat of being dove. However, this Azir is playing very aggressively. Sossen forcing Victor back into the jungle out of the mid lane while he knows that he's trying to get this blue buff. So Catch is, with so much pressure in mid and bottom, Catch is able just to sit there without any repercussions, and they get a bunch of damage down onto the tower.
Yeah. Wow. Well, KT barely defends their bottom and hip, or bottom tower.
Well, I wonder if KT will get an earlier Aegis this game, considering they are playing against Corki, Azir, and Ryze. You'd think that this might be just a little bit important.
I think that's a pretty good idea.
And it was woefully neglected in the last game.
Yeah. Probably something for Score to consider picking up.
So there you go. Gets another blue buff, so Nagne may have some more pressure, and they are going to take a tower to more or less even things out when it comes to the global gold, and now all sights set in a minute and a half on this next dragon. It should be an interesting one, depending on what Spenu can do and how much they want to commit with the Ryze. The fact that they got that first dragon means that they're not so worried about this next one. They don't have to go for it. Ryze is already in a very good place.
Yeah.
And there's no threat of KT getting to those five dragon stacks anytime soon because the first dragon went down so early.
Well, it's interesting. I mean, Spenu's gotten six dragons in a row now. There goes the bottom turret in favor of Spenu as well, too. So they've gotten all three outer turrets down. Someday lurking about in the mid lane. Sossen just farming well.
I really have to wonder what is so insane about Soul's Rumble that it caused this much priority away from clearly power pick champions like Ryze and Ezreal.
Yeah.
To take over this series. Why did Someday have to play Ryze? Why did they have to ban Rumble on the red side? Why couldn't they just ban Ryze? Because I've seen Soul's Rumble and it doesn't terrify me.
Maybe it was just an off game.
Off couple of games in terms of pick and ban priority, just bizarre, frankly. KT definitely has a better composition than they had last time, but
they're in a good position to take out this next dragon, too.
And fortunately for them, again, Rise is going to have a very, very hard time against this team in the late game.
Yeah.
As long as they get to the point where they can really start grouping as five.
Well, it's just hard to imagine Rise, you know, getting in onto the damage dealers for KT late game.
Yeah, or anybody, really.
Yeah, if they build MR, he's going to be pretty marginalized. Him and Azir both.
Looks like Score is going for a fast Aegis this time. So they have fixed their wacky itemization from game number two. Definitely building a lot smarter this time. Someday should be just going straight for a Spirit Visage.
Yeah, we'll see. Spenders managed to maneuver their way in front of the dragon again, and they've got great warding down.
Soul also just walking from the top side. They have good wards to see where this Maokai is.
Yeah, and this all happened in like the last 30 seconds or so. Spenders just coming in, getting all the wards, and they're going for that second dragon.
TP.
Teleport coming in for Someday right now. They might have to back off. Nagne coming from the side, but he can't go too aggressive because all of Spenu is right there.
Yeah, he's now cut off. And you don't really want to be a flank victor unless you're GBM and doing the ultimate surprise attack.
Yeah, that worked for him. Once.
Once it did. They're really too far spread out right now. This is the problem with having that mid turret already down as KT gets there. It's too easy for Spenu to control that choke point between the mid lane and the river.
Yeah.
We'll actually, Nagne slipped through.
Now.
Oh,
yeah.
Interesting.
He actually made it through. They scared Spenu off enough with the poke from Arrow that he was able to make it through. That does allow Sasan to push the lane. Spenu, this dragon's going down. Can Ketch come in and get it? They find Someday. They prevent the flank. Dragon getting very low. Ketch going right in. They don't get the dragon. It does go to KT. Soul comes in. Everyone gets knocked back by Secret, but KT's looking very good in this team fight. Catching a little bit of trouble as Someday goes into the back lines. Nobody dead on KT just yet. So two kills and a dragon. That's more like what KT was looking for.
And Peekaboo really did nail the combo so that they could get the necessary damage down. But that's part of the issue is Spenu. Soul did pretty much nothing during that fight. He was just CC'd forever and then blasted by Arrow and Nagne, dropping that Chaos Storm very early. Now they're going to get just an Azir turret too, but that was also a split call from Spenu because Sasan is still working his way over. Now watch this. Just a very convincing engage. And Someday and Peekaboo, they're just taking all the damage. They're already tanky enough to deal with this. And Nagne just gets free shots onto Ketch because they have no way to get onto the back line.
It was not
there's no threat for Kog'Maw for Victor.
It was really not a good flash ultimate for Secret either. It really got pretty much nothing done. Probably should have saved that one.
Yeah. In fact, it arguably hurt his team because he just put Alistar and Maokai further into his carries.
Yep, and then he didn't have the heal to push back when everyone else engaged.
But basically, as soon as that engage comes in from KT and they start the team fight, they can just turn around, kite back like we saw a little bit, wait for all of Spenu to use their limited forms of CC and then just walk forward. Nagne was just going nuts in that fight in terms of damage because no one was able to touch him.
Well, 3-0-1 now on that Victor, and he's off to a really good start. Picked up a very fast Void Staff after he got the Abyssal Scepter.
I don't even know why he has that Void Staff. That is not a good use of money.
I mean, there is a locket on the Spenu side.
Yeah, but he has an Abyssal. Why he does not need a Void Staff right now.
No.
That is ridiculous. There's no other MR on the team besides a locket, and you're already going to have enough flat penetration to pretty effectively deal with that item. So getting percent penetration is just incredibly inefficient.
Well, at least it gives you AP too.
I guess could have gotten literally anything. Probably should have gotten a very fast Lich Bane, actually, this game in particular, because that's little boost of speed, considering that he's going to be untouched and that he's going to get a lot of auto attacks down in a team fight because he's going to be close enough without actually being in danger would be quite good. But
we'll see what he can do with it. Spenu pushing up the mid lane a little bit. And wow, some action onto Secret. Knock-up, headbutt, pulverized. Secret getting caught there. Uses his ultimate. Not really going to help him too much. He's still going to go down. And KT, there's the ultimate from Peekaboo. Thought they might want to continue engaging, but turning around. So Peekaboo kind of wasting his ult there.
Yep, and we'll see. They may try and bait a Baron. I don't know. Someday's just a tad too low. Someday just has to get back into lane to catch the wave that Soul is bringing to his doorstep. But Soul not using his TP right there. They caught somebody out. And even though they had the TP advantage, they couldn't really do much. Arrow, in the meantime, will take out the top turret. So
yep.
Clean turret kill, and he'll walk away. Now they're going to try
teleport.
Teleport.
Soul trying to come in onto Arrow here, but Peekaboo's right there with the pulverize. He walked right into it. Score coming in. They're going to catch him, throwing him against the wall. There's the exhaust as well. And Soul, very tanky, taking a lot of damage. Whoa, he gets the kill on the Arrow. Double kill as well as he takes out Score. That is insane. A double kill for Soul. Ryze is pretty strong right now.
I don't know about Peekaboo headbutting him closer to the Kog'Maw in that situation.
The
considering
pulverize was good, but yeah.
Yeah, the headbutt afterwards, really questionable from Peekaboo. Still a really dangerous Baron to do with the Chaos Storm about to start swirling on their flanks.
Oh, if they can get in. Sasa doing a good job of zoning here.
Where's Maokai? There he is.
Coming in now. Nagne still needs to get there, though.
Oh,
Baron
geez.
Getting low. Oh, and Someday, he got the Baron. Nagne comes in for a lot of damage. There's a double kill for Someday as well. And Spenu has made a huge error. Oh man, Sasan trying to clean stuff up. He's able to finally take down Someday, but they lost the Baron. They lost a lot of team members. Wow.
That was so risky with their low HP. They're all getting shredded here, and Maokai just going to come in, and I don't even know how he gets this.
He just autos it or something.
No,
his ult, I think. Yeah.
His ult got it. So, and then Soul is on the flank here, but meantime, they hit a huge Chaos Storm on four low members because Nagne was just sitting there while they were all clumped up with a bunch of Magic Shred. What an awful decision from Spenu.
No kidding. Wow.
I mean, even if they had gotten the Baron, it was still bad.
Well, Spenu just getting a little bit too excited there.
Okay, now he's going to build Lich Mane. Whatever. I'm done with KT's itemization in this series. It confuses and alarms me.
Does it disturb you even?
No, I don't feel very disturbed.
You going to go home and cry about it? You going to cry? Cry, Monty? Cry about that itemization?
Nope.
You sure?
Yes.
Okay. Because right. If you need to, I understand. I'm here for you, man. Well, dragging up in 19 seconds. You got to wonder if the morale for Spenny has just been shattered, though, after that.
Probably isn't too good. And that dragon should be number two. We have a very late dragon game this time.
Yeah. 1-1 on Dragon so far. KT wants this one. They want it bad.
Yeah, they only have a couple members who actually have the Baron buff, though, so it's not like they're so much stronger.
I believe it's only one. I think it's only Peekaboo, actually. Yeah, nobody else seems to have it.
Yep.
Everyone was dead or either died in the fight.
Oh, Dragon
Whirlwind
reset.
Comes in. That's right. Yeah, KT having a little bit of a struggle with this one. The poke is still good. Score doing it. Catch comes in. Score still gets the dragon. Catch is going to get taken down. The rest of the fight happening. Peekaboo goes in for the headbutt. Pulverize onto Sasan. Wow, that's a big Chaos Storm. A lot of damage coming in from Nagne. He's going to grab a killer too. Secret taken out by Arrow in the back lines. And that's another double for Nagne after that dragon. Only Nuclear making it out.
After Catch goes into the pit, there's no more initiation. So you just see that as soon as they turn on to Catch right there, they can just immediately go on to the rest of the team. Nagne even flashed forward to kill the Ryze because there's just zero threat. I mean, Spenu's composition, sure, they had a nice skirmish, and you could skirmish very effectively with this comp, but in the 5v5 fights, there's just way too much crowd control from the KT front line and just nothing there from Spenu.
Yeah, well, KT's just going to push right through here and go for an inhibitor. Spenu, there's a knock-up on the score. Needs to be a little bit careful there. Yeah, KT maybe even overextending slightly themselves as well after that.
Well, they're just going to get out of there. Even though the inhibitor gets down to about 10%, they don't want to overcommit. That is the right call. They can always just come back for it in a couple of minutes. Now that they know how well they can do in these 5v5s. Just watch this. So Ketch is going to get out on the side, but they just have no way to engage on this backlight. There were two of the tanks were in the pit, and they couldn't even commit to killing Victor. And then Nagne just has the balls to flash forward into two of them, and his damage is huge as this Victor, but you should not be able to do that kind of play like Nagne did.
Well, he had a huge Death Ray Chaos Storm combo on three members of the team that were hit by the Headbutt Pulverizer Peekaboo. That was a nice little wombo combo from KT.
Yeah, you could say Peekaboo did a nice job zoning, and that's true.
That too.
But when Gragas and Maokai are inside the pit and Victor is standing there poking you, you need to have a way to actually kill him. Because you can't just be allowed to do that with a support ulting, with an ulting Alistar.
You'd hope so, right?
Right. So, just these team fights are actually very easy for KT.
Mm-hmm. Well, that was kind of the intent with the comp, I suppose. And now KT with a very comfortable 5K gold lead. With this type of comp against the type of comp that Spenu has, it should be... should be fairly simple to close it out.
Yeah, especially now that Nagne has the Lich Bane. His consistent DPS in these fights is going to be really, really big.
Should be nice. Yep. And Maokai, Christmas Maokai, putting the gifts under him again in this game. He decides, I want nuclear for Christmas.
Well, he could have whoever he wants, really.
Pretty much.
This point, just absolutely a tanky monster. Nothing really they can do, and especially two Righteous Glories on KT. Peekaboo opting for, interesting, he didn't go for the coin this game. Well, catch.
Yeah. Oh, all right. Catch trying to get away. Makes it out. A little bit of skirmishing. But can Spenu defend this inhibitor? That's the tough part. Sasson's got a lot of zoning with this Azir, but it's going to be pretty tough if KT really wants it. Get out of here.
Go back to your base, Catch.
Wants to protect that ward.
That ward cannot see the other ward.
Wow, you're right.
Otherwise, Peekaboo would be clearing that.
You'd think so.
Azir turret goes down as the final line of defense, just buying as much time as they can. So what KT should do is just say screw it and start trying to bait the Baron.
It looks like that's what they're doing as they move up through the jungle of Spenu. Not a lot of wards around Baron, but KT knows exactly where Spenu is right now, so not a big concern.
Yeah, they also have a very nice minion wave in top developing. Looks like that'll just be cleared immediately, considering there is no immediate Baron threat. So this Azir Tower going to be falling pretty soon.
Well, they certainly want to take it out.
Everyone just setting up for this. Crab gonna go into the hands of KT with 30 seconds remaining. They have prevented any kind of wards on the objective by Spenu. They have a scrying orb, but as soon as that's gone, they will be blind. No mass recalls from KT, just very patient vision play around the Baron, making sure that there isn't any chance that someone slips in there into the river for a ward.
KT really playing out these few minutes pretty safely.
Yeah, much more methodically.
Yeah. So they stole the last Baron. Are they going to be able to take this one cleanly?
Well, where is the orb? There's the orb, so now they know they aren't doing it. So now that is usually the point where you start trying to take the Baron.
KT really wants to fight, it looks like.
Well, that would make things a lot easier. They certainly have the engage to fight, which is why we see Spenu falling back so far. They know if they get anywhere near these two Righteous Glories, that they are going to get caught.
Mm-hmm. Now you can just turn around on the Baron. And they can really bait this all day, too. They're going to start it.
Yeah, they can. Somebody's just going to take zero damage from this objective.
Nuclear is pretty far away, too.
Well, catches there. Managed to sneak around the side to put himself in range of a Burrow Steal, and Peekaboo took a lot of poke.
Yeah.
Somewhere.
It's going to push up top lane, I suppose. Go for that tier 2, maybe. Ah, but it's a rush down mid for Spenu.
I don't know if this is very smart. They're just going to
give
up Baron
for this, yeah. Well, they think they can get there in time. We'll see if they can zone. They get the tier 2. Catch is right there. Wants to try to steal it himself here, but Peekaboo zoning. He's got that ultimate as well. Baron getting very, very low. Goes down in favor of KT. And here's the fight. Spenu in a little bit of trouble. They're all clumped up behind things, but they poked out KT fairly well. Score is going to have a hard time getting through try. They're going to pop that Righteous Glory to try to get a little bit more mobility. Sossin over the wall. KT bottled up. A little bit low health. They're having to kind of kite this one out.
I don't know if they actually have the tools. Spenu, I don't know if they can get onto.
I don't know, man. KT, oh, that's a lot of damage on the catch.
Poked right here.
That's right. Someday going in on the catch now. There we go. Headbutt pulverize in to score. Score a little bit low. Soul low. Arrow takes him out. Arrow, though, trades. Nuclear gets a kill as well. Two come in for Spenu. KT chasing through. They're going to get the AD carry. Nice pulverize on the Nuclear. And Pickaboo's going to pick up a Bloodthirsty one as well. Knock up onto Someday, though. Spenu's still chasing. And they're actually going to come out of this fight ahead. Over the wall, and there's a kill for Sossin. Wow, Spenu really punishing this Baron.
I do not know why Ryze keeps getting bounced on top of the Kog'Maw. Arrow is having such a difficult time this game because his teammates keep putting the Ryze next to him.
It's not a good idea.
Just be a front line and keep Ryze tied up so that Ryze just deals damage to the tanks instead of putting a ridiculous amount of damage onto the Kog'Maw in all these skirmishes.
Spenu's going to get another dragon out of this as well. Oh, boy.
Well, I mean, realistically, it doesn't really matter. There's still two members with the Baron buff. There's an open inhibitor that they can take with the Baron as soon as Someday actually respawns, but it's not a very good team fight from KT. If they had just stuck together and walked backwards down the lane, KT, they could have just kited KT forever.
Yeah.
See, watch this. You don't split up right here. First off, Victor is awkwardly positioned. Where is the front line? And then, what? Score just bounces Soul right into Arrow. And then they have to move him again away. And this, meanwhile, Nagane is just left on the side. If you just have Arrow and Nagane together with your front lane, they just kept walking down the lane towards the base of Spenu, they would have been fine.
Weird.
Instead, this happens.
Well, they ended up in a very awkward position. Spenu took full advantage of it.
You don't really have to be worried about those minion waves at this late stage of the game. Another Aegis for Someday, so double lock it. That's actually a smart decision in this particular situation.
Well, they're going to go in onto this inhibitor turret. Azir turret there first with the Janna shield, so it's going to take a little while to power through it.
That's a huge minion wave, though.
Yeah, with the Baron buff, they shouldn't have much of a trouble. Or maybe I spoke too soon.
Oh, they'll get it. I mean, they have Baron empowered siege minions, and they have Kog'Maw there with his W. So, there you go. Goodbye.
We're going after the inhibitor now. Another wave coming in. This has taken a while for KT, but they're slowly grinding their way in, and now they should be able to take that inhibitor unless Spenu goes for some sort of miracle engage. We'll see if they do. Sossin looking like he may want to come around the side, but nope. KT gets the inhibitor. They get out. That's going to help quite a bit. There's still 6,000 gold ahead, even after that last fight.
Yeah, now they could just push down the remaining tier 2s, so they're in a very comfortable position to close. They also have a banner of command, so not even double lock it. They're just going to be using the banner to create more siege pressure.
Makes sense.
And now we're going to have a pause.
Good. I was hoping the suspense would continue to build. Looks like Sossin needs a drink of water. Okay.
You don't have to pause for a drink of water, Sossin.
No, it's got to be something else. Oh, maybe Sossin does need to pause for a drink of water. He was parched. The Shurima Desert stuff got a little bit too real for him, I guess.
He started role-playing. He's not drinking water while he was playing Azir.
He's like, I've been trapped under a sand tomb for thousands of years. I need water. All right. Are you hydrated now? We've had bathroom breaks, we've had water breaks this season. Really anything goes at this point.
Actually, CJ was warned for that space bathroom break.
I know, yeah. That was pretty funny.
Sometimes it's just an emergency.
Hey, when you gotta go, you gotta go.
That's why your team gets penalized, because you have to think ahead about bodily functions, Della.
That's true. You know, sometimes you drink a whole liter of Mountain Dew right before a 50-minute game.
Well, that is disgusting. Who does that?
I fear many people do. Yep.
If you drink a whole liter of Mountain Dew at once, viewers, I think you are disgusting.
It is not a good idea. I do not recommend it. I mean, we've all had those. Well, maybe you haven't. But, I mean, we as in me and my fellow WoW nerds have all had. We've all had those nights where it's a pizza and Mountain Dew for like 12 hours. It's happened. You don't feel proud or good, but it's fun. Yeah.
Gross.
It was. It was an experience.
I was never a WoW nerd because I think that game sucks.
Well, you are in the minority because it's actually a really good game.
I'm definitely not in the minority of gamers.
No, but you're in the minority of opinions on MMOs. Well, we have no idea what the holdup is. It could be just a very long pause for dramatic effects. It almost looks like Sausen's arm was bothering him. Honestly.
It looks like it's actually something going on in the KT booth.
Yeah.
Huh. There's Peekaboo on your screen.
Let's start wildly speculating. What do you want to? I think they just got a call that like a robot has come from the future to try to kill Sausen. Some representatives from Super Evil Megacorp there. They make Vainglory.
Right. They do. What kind of robot is this who comes from the future? Is he John Connor?
I don't know. I don't know. It shouldn't be a Terminator. You and I were talking about this earlier today that like the Terminator movies makes no sense at all because, all right, if you're super advanced, hyper smart robots from the future and you send a robot back to kill some dude and it doesn't work, you don't just give up. Like literally there should be no way that John Connor can survive ever because the robots will just keep trying.
Yeah, or just why are you sending a robot when you could just teleport a bomb to whatever you want?
Exactly. Why not just take a plane and like nuke the hospital he's born in? Like you can
Well, even if you didn't even have a plane, let's just say that was too big. You could just send a bomb to a specific point in time and location. It doesn't have to be a big one, just a small one.
Hey, it works in Stargate.
Yeah, exactly. Or even better idea, how about you don't fight John Connor when he's capable of resisting?
Seriously.
How about when he's an infant?
Why don't you go back to like the Old West when there was no technology to just kill his like ancestors or something?
Why don't you just trace his lineage back like 200 years and then go back then? When that robot would have kicked everybody's ass because nothing could have killed that thing.
Exactly. When like that robot shows up like somewhere in Europe where John Connor's ancestors were from and just like destroys them with a laser beam. Like, I don't know. What are his ancestors going to do? Nothing. Terminators.
They're
going
to die.
And why? This was a good point you brought up. Why does the T-800 keep looking older? Why do they keep making models that look older than the last ones?
That really doesn't make any sense.
It's like you have to add some gray hair. I don't know. And why? See, here, the thing is, though, is maybe they did plan on sending someone back to Europe before. Maybe John Connor's ancestors are Austrian, which is why they gave it the Austrian accent. These robots from the future. And then at the last minute, they're like, let's go to America instead. They're like, well, we've still got the accent, the Austrian accent. They're like, we'll just keep it. No one will notice.
Yeah, that also is very confusing. If you want your robot to be inconspicuous at the time in which you send it back, please do not give it some incredibly obvious accent that just forces people to ask very uncomfortable questions to your robot.
Or don't make it like huge and scary so everyone notices it.
Yeah, why would you make it some giant beefy guy? Why just make it something normal looking? You don't need Mr. Universe to kill your target who is a teenage boy.
All you have to do is make it a hyper intelligent like squirrel. Nobody suspects the squirrel, man. When that squirrel's like arms when it's like hands pop down and like guns come out, nobody's going to see that coming. When the tail starts spinning and it ends up being like a razor like saw blade. No, nobody's going to be able to defend John Connor against that. You don't need, like, a semi-truck or a shotgun or anything like that.
Well, I'm just glad I'm never going to see the new Terminator movie.
It doesn't look very good. You know.
I mean, do any of them really look good?
Yep. Daenerys from Game of Thrones is in that, though.
I don't care.
It would be – I would like it
She's
better
the worst actor in Game of Thrones.
At some point,
bad in Game of Thrones.
But she would bring possibly the scene where, like, the dragons show up, you know? Which would be really cool.
I guess it's going to be us now. I'm not wearing a jacket because I got too warm.
You're so casual. Wow. Maybe I should take off my jacket and be casual with you. But my shirt doesn't fit very well at all this season, so I'm just going to keep it on. This is as good as I can look.
We just have no idea what's going on right now.
No.
We're just here to talk about Terminator.
We're not really informed by things that happen, really, per se.
It's a good way to be.
I'm waiting for Boom Cameron to make an appearance. This will be about the time he drops by, really. That's usually about it. Yep.
He's a good boom camera.
He's a good boom camera. He gets He wants the spotlight for himself a little bit, so he likes to show up. Yeah. He knows he can show up on our stream, so he gets away with it here. He never tries to pull that on the Korean stream.
He's just too far away from the Korean stream camera, though. That's the thing.
That's true. He's a perfect place to go over ours, though. What a great place for that one there. Yep. So, I talked about Terminator, a little bit of Game of Thrones in there. Boom camera.
Daenerys is, whoever that woman who plays Daenerys is, like, the worst actor on that show, though, for sure. They have a great cast for the most part, but she is just... This is bad.
It's a bit on the bland side.
Yeah.
I agree.
How could you take a character who controls dragons and who has incited slave revolts and controls an army to overthrow a city and is supposed to be authoritative? How do you even make that character boring? Congratulations, actress. You figured it out.
Wow. You are really... You know, if any of them watch Champions, now they're never going to come and hang out at the studio. Thanks a lot, Monte Cristo.
That's not true, because here's what I think. What? So if anybody from Game of Thrones, they probably, all of the other actors on that show are probably thinking right now, she does suck.
Yeah?
Because I was an actor, so I know how they think.
Really?
I was in theater for a long time.
What was the most challenging role you've ever played?
Richard III.
Really?
Yeah.
How'd that turn out?
Great.
For Richard III?
Not great.
Not so great.
He tried to give his kingdom for a horse, and it didn't work out very well for him.
Which is weird, because there's horses everywhere back then. You'd think it'd be really easy. If I like my kingdom for a horse, I'd be like, yeah, sure, man. I mean... But I have to be like a vassal to whatever army you're losing to. I'm still going to be rich. Like, sure, here's my horse. I don't know. Some pretty dumb people in his kingdom. Maybe that's why they lost.
Well, it was in the middle of the battle when he said that. So a little bit different situation, right?
Yeah, I mean, I guess you kind of need the horse to get away.
Yeah, no. Well, what if, really to do anything.
What if you just like say, hop up, Richard. Richard, come on. Hop up on the horse. We can ride together. There's enough room on this horse for two. Nobody wants Richard to ride the horse.
Well, he was a hunchback, you know.
Oh. You played a hunchback? Were you all hunched when you did the role?
Yes, you have to. He's a hunchback.
I don't know. Why are there not pictures of this?
There are pictures of it.
Really? Yeah. Would you be willing to release them on social media?
No, I would not.
I think if we all tweet at RNG Monte Cristo and ask him to release Richard III pictures, if you'd like to see Hunchback Monte Cristo. Because I know I do.
I also had a goatee for that part, too. So it's even better.
Oh, man.
It's even better.
We need to see this.
No.
You brought this up. I'm an actor. I was Richard III.
Yeah.
And then you refused
to show
people.
That's also my favorite monologue in Galaxy Quest. You know? I was an actor
once.
I played Richard III.
That's right. Do you feel similar? Grab Thar's hammer.
I actually do. You know what? I really do share a lot with Alan Rickman's character in that movie, because Alan Rickman, you know why he was so hurt by the fact that he had to have this position is because he remembered the time when he was respected for his job as an actor, right? When he was respected, like I used to be respected for my analysis, and then I blew a train whistle, and now that's all everyone talks about.
It was, well, that's because humor is better than analysis. I can't speak English anymore. These pauses are not supposed to go on this long.
I'm just unloading all of my emotional baggage tonight, though.
Well, I'm glad you're here. You've taken off. We're getting very casual now. Do you need, like, a couch to lie back on? I bet that chair reclines a little bit. You can recline.
You know what?
What?
You are the last person I want to have analyze me and my psychological issues.
I'm really nice, though. I'm a good listener. I'm understanding. And I prescribe, like, video games for everything, so can't go wrong there.
Hard to argue with that kind of treatment, I guess.
Yeah. Well, they'll make you happy again. Just don't play something depressing. Can you think of some really depressing video games?
I'm sure there are some.
I mean, I can think of video games that I was depressed while playing because they're that bad, but...
WoW?
No, not WoW. But I mean, really actually video games that make you feel sad. I felt kind of sad at the end of Shadow of the Colossus.
That was a
great game.
That was a good game.
Yeah,
they're making a new one, I think, now.
Yeah, well, I mean, same like...
Same concept as Eco or...
Well, same like...
Developer?
Yeah. Developer okay. Studio, whatever you want to call it. Whatever sounds more fancy, I guess. I like that. I don't know if it's going to be good, but the last two were really good, so.
I think the odds are pretty solid. That's going to be a decent game.
You never know when you're going to go from Return of the Jedi to Phantom Menace, though. That was the day.
You never know when you're gonna pull a Phantom Menace.
You never know when you're gonna go from game one KD versus Penu to game two KD versus Penu.
It's true. There are no guarantees in life, are there?
That's true.
Or game three, which is now we're just working on this pause at the moment.
This has been one of our longest pauses ever. It's been about 12 minutes at this point.
12 minutes in.
Yeah, I wonder what's going on in the booth, whichever booth it is. Things looked like they were going fine, but I guess not. Nope.
Everything's broken. It'll never be fixed again.
The system is down. There was a new Strong Bad thing.
Really?
Yeah, like a couple months ago.
Oh.
Nothing really since then, as far as I know.
Oh, I'll have to look it up.
Yeah, I love those, man. Every Thursday night, the new Strong Bad email will come out. We get pizza. And we'd watch it. We need like a lot more to watch after that because it's only like 5 minutes. We needed something to fill the other pizza eating time, but we'd find something.
I'm glad your life consisted of what to watch while you ate pizza, Noah.
That's college, man.
To be fair, the audience here did have something to watch while they ate their pizza. We filled their pizza eating time super well.
You know, I find like more and more as time goes on. Like if I'm eating by myself. I need like something else to do at the same time. I can't just like focus on the food. Maybe I just need to cook better food. But I like always watch a stream or something.
I think you're just getting too distracted, though. You need to just sit there and enjoy one thing at a time. Stop all the multitasking garbage. Just focus, you know?
You're so wise.
Meditation is for you.
Maybe I need a couch. Just, like lean back and you can like analyze myself. I'm like, you know, I really could use...
Meditation.
Pizza right now.
No, yeah. Not pizza. Meditation.
Oh, I meant to say meditation. But pizza just slipped out. I haven't had pizza for a while, actually. Yeah.
Also, Korean pizza is questionable in its quality.
It's usually really greasy, which is awful. And it's also got corn in it, which is the ultimate offense to good pizza everywhere, is put corn in it. If you like corn in your pizza, you're weird.
Look, I like corn, and if you just told me, if I didn't know better, and you're like, hey, there's corn on this pizza, I'd say, okay, that sounds kind of weird, but not that bad.
That's
but
what I said the first time.
It's actually terrible.
That's what I said the first time when I came to Korea 4 years ago, and I'm like, oh, corn on pizza, all right. I'll broaden my horizons. I'll try it. I'm like, no, this is terrible. This is really awful, awful pizza. But Korea loves it.
It's really hard to get pizza without corn on it.
Yeah, you specifically have to ask to not have corn in most cases. Because even if you get like a pepperoni pizza, they'll still put corn in it.
Corn gets in
there. We're not even making this up. Like, I'm not even kidding when I say that one of the first things I learned how to say in Korea was no corn, please. Because I would like get a pizza and I'd be like, I got cheese pizza and you put corn in it. Why would you do this? It doesn't go in the tomato. It's not part of the tomato sauce. You can't make that argument. It's just corn. Why do they always do that?
I don't know. I do like the sweet potato, though.
Yeah, that's actually pretty good.
That actually is okay on pizza.
But they put, like, mayonnaise and stuff on pizza, too, which is not. Yeah.
I don't even know.
No, it's not good. And, like, honey mustard and stuff? No. Like, if you have, like, crust you can dip in it, sure. But not on the pizza.
That's a weird thing about Western food in general, right? Is that Korean food is not sweet. But when Koreans make Western food, it gets a ton of sugar in it somehow.
It's ridiculously sweet. Like, all the bread is really sweet here. All the like, pizza and everything is really sweet. But, yeah, well, like, regular Korean food is not sweet.
I don't understand why they even think that Western food is sweet, because it's not even remotely like this.
American food better add some sugar. No. No, Korea, that's racist. No.
You tell him.
That's right. It's time for me to unload a little bit here.
Oh, we're going to get back into the game.
Whoa, no way. 3, 2, 1.
Oh, we're going to check it first. Make sure everything's okay.
Oh, we're okay. All right. We've made it through the pause. Well done, Monte Cristo.
We did it
excellent
again.
Job. Yeah. Well done. Okay. Well, KT's pretty far ahead. Nothing has changed there in the pause. 7,000 gold in the lead as they push down the bot lane. Man, I hate pizza with corn in it. Pretty good wave clear for Spenu, though, so I wonder how long they'll be able to hold this off, because somebody's pushing down the top lane right now.
Yep, just going to start the split push on the last couple of tier 2s. He doesn't have a Baron buff, though.
Yeah, but I guess Soul can probably stop him. Yeah.
Soul should be in a perfectly decent position to do that, especially because his ultimate is already back up. just sitting there will be perfectly fine.
Well, score got poked out by Sossin a moment ago. Pretty hardcore. Ooh, catch over the wall for some strange reason. And he's going to be in a little bit of trouble. Nagne and Arrow pushed away, though. They have no one really protecting them right now.
No, they can't be split like that from their tank line. That is not a good position for them to be in.
It's dangerous. All right, they really want this red buff. Oh, meanwhile, Sol trying to defend the turrets, but that one Nexus turret has taken quite a bit of damage.
Yeah, they're going to be able to get this red buff unless there's a smite steal that comes in from Spenu. Should be able to get it onto Arrow. Nagne just going to take a bunch of poke damage,
Whoa.
Though.
Yeah, you got to be careful.
Quite
there.
Strong.
Yeah, and a little bit easier for him to poke from range with those sand soldiers than Nagne with the death ray.
I don't know. Death ray is pretty good for poking.
Yeah, but I mean, you can reposition the sand soldiers. They have a wider degree of where they can hit, whereas a death ray, you miss it, and then you have to wait for the cooldown.
True enough. Well, looks like we're going to be back to baiting at ye old Baron.
I think like KT's just trying to like remember what they were doing before the pause. They're like, what? How many turrets are down? Okay. All right. And Sol just going to pop his ultimate to mow through, or not even the ultimate, to just go through the wave there.
Well, Ryze is quite terrifying. It's just the question remains whether he can actually do anything with all this power he has accumulated. More and more MR stacked onto Someday and Score at this point in time.
I mean, KT is way ahead, but this is still a winnable game for Spenu.
Well, if KT really messed up on their positioning, maybe, but
yeah,
KT is pretty in control of this game, and they have a pretty easy way just to team fight their way to a victory. And they also are going to have control over this mid lane with the super minions right as the Baron spawns. So they're going to be feeling just fine, I think.
And yeah, KT just going right back to baiting that Baron. Got to get Nucleus over there again, or Arrow rather. Nucleus pushing up the mid lane right now.
Yep, just want to get that position. They need to get a few more wards in. They don't have any lenses available to help them out at the moment. Arrow needs another red buff, or they actually decide to complete this bait. There's still a ward within the Baron pit itself that has not been cleared. It's been cleverly placed right inside the lip of the pit, so hard to discover. There's an Azir turret going down to just a mid-wave push. Someday is just incredibly tanky at the moment.
Yeah. KT's got a good position on this Baron. They finally found the last ward.
No, they have not.
Oh, really?
There is one still in the pit.
Yeah, they found it. Oh, there's one in the pit. I didn't see that one. I hadn't found the last ward either.
You're in the dark just like KT is.
I guess so. Well, they're going to go to mid lane anyway. They want to try to take that dragon, I guess.
Well, this is a bit risky to split like this. You really want to be all together, because if Arrow's found alone by the Ryze, he's going to be able to chase him down just with the speed boost from his ultimate, more than likely.
Well, there's no wards over there, so KT can pull this off,
like the bannered minion in the bottom lane.
Yep, and smart.
Somebody's going to have to go deal with that. Fortunately, Sol does have TP, but he doesn't have a lot of TP options.
Oh, mid inhibitor's back.
And I guess Peekaboo decided it's time to recall right now. What did he get?
Face of the Mountain?
No, he already had Face of the Mountain.
Ruby Sightstone?
Maybe Ruby and
Kindle Gem?
He got a pink ward, so huge side wave pressure. And that's going to pick off the tier two in the bottom sides. And that's going to be them just doing it over. But they have not accounted for this ward.
Yeah, they haven't seen it yet. The Baron is dropping very fast, but Spenu knows exactly what's up. KT must be aware that they know now, too. They're backing off. Yeah, they found Sol, though. Caught him a little bit. Nagne getting very low. Ketch getting in with the knockup as well. Spenu, they're going for it, man. Ketch gets very low. There's a kill for Nagne, though. And Emperor's Divide pushes everybody back. Double kill for Nagne and KT. They can just turn onto this Baron if they want to. Nagne still going after Ketch. There's a triple kill for Nagne on that Victor. Wow.
Yeah, well, this just has no threat, and they're just going to go right in right now. TP straight towards the inhibitor. They have a Lich Bane. They have a Trinity Force, and they can definitely get this. As long as Nagne doesn't die, Nuclear trying to get some damage onto Nagne, prevent him from grouping up, but that's not going to work. And someday, they're going to cut off their exit back into their own base. I mean, Nuclear just on the outside looking in.
Yeah, they're going to go after these Nexus turrets now, and with the long death timers that Soul Catch and Sassen have to deal with, it looks like this is going to be it. And KT Rolster looks like they will take that 2-1 victory over Spenusonic Boom. Thought it'd be 2-0, but interesting match to say the least. That is it. GG.
Yeah, that is going to be it. And KT, well, at least they take the victory if it wasn't cleanly. Spenu putting up much more of a fight here this evening. KT very methodical in the last game, playing out their composition pretty much properly. And I think the draft from Spenu hurt them quite a bit with their inability to get onto the carries.
Yeah, no, it's disappointing. I mean, Spenu, again, giving themselves a chance to win a match this season and having it slip away yet again. But taking a win off of KT is a pretty big accomplishment for that team. It's certainly the strongest team that they've